It's your boy N.O.R.E.
What up, it's DJ EFN.
This meditative crazy wall, motherfucking drink chaps, yappy yabba, make some noise! Now, this show is built.
I hate when he does
that. Listen, this show is built for the person that we got and we interviewing today. This show is built for people like that. This show has been built on us praising our legends. You know, our legends, why they're here. When you talk about like 11 albums, six Geto Boys, 11 of his solo. When you talk about bars, when you talk about a man, they say wine ages with time. This is probably why the only MC that got better. Like his whole career, he just kept getting better. The storytelling from everything from the street tales, this man is a pure, pure legend. He's your rapper's favorite rapper. Everybody's favorite rapper, he's on that list. He's in everyone's top five. He's one of the illest individuals I ever met. He can get down on the guitar. He can get down on producing. He can get down on whatever the fuck you wanted him to get down on. He can get down. He's a motherfucking stone cold, super, super duper legend. He's everyone's OG. He's your OG OG.
You missed one thing.
What's that?
Since day one of Drink Champs, we've been trying to get him
since day one. So, Case, you don't know who the fuck we talking about. We talking about the legendary Mr. Scarface!
I'm looking around like, who in the fuck is this dude talking about?
No, we talking about you.
Somebody special.
Listen, first off, we want to give you a bottle because I'm drinking whiskey now, too. I just got on the whiskey, but I'm Japanese whiskey.
Oh, so shit. If you start speaking another language,
No, you're good. So we got you Macallan 18.
Mr. Lee's this the bottle boy.
Oh, shit. You got the fucking...
We've been doing Drink Chance for six years.
We're on 6 years right now.
Six years. This is the first time anybody has ordered Macallan. This is the first time anybody has ordered Macallan.
Really?
Yeah, what is Macallan? That's whiskey, correct?
It's a scotch.
It's a scotch.
It's my favorite.
Mm. Yeah.
And I would like to share some with you guys.
Okay, cool. Cool.
But I'm not.
That shit's gonna be
You can take it home with you if you want. You can take it home with you if you want. Yeah. Come on, let's get him some ice. Let's get him some ice, Mr. Lee.
Man, this is fantastic, dude. This is a special. This is like I almost want to break down, man. I'm getting fucking emotional.
Nah,
let's say that for the second half.
Because we got some shit for you,
like,
Face.
I'm emotional right now.
We excited, man.
Do you realize how much you're loved in this? Help him out.
Don't do that.
Okay.
Let me enjoy this part of it first, man. I like a lot of ice. Yeah, man. Yeah. I want to share some of this with my son.
Okay. That's what's up. Where your son at?
My kid. Hey, kid, come get some. Come share some of this with your pop.
Okay.
This shit's not... You're going to love this, son.
Okay.
It's for you, God. It's for my boy.
So look, let me ask you a question while we getting it together.
Talk to me.
The first Geto Boy album, you wasn't a part of the first Geto Boy album?
No, I wasn't there yet. I was still a kid, man. I think I was probably like 10 or 12 when they did that motherfucker.
Wow. But was Bushwick
and Willie D?
And Willie D a part of it?
Willie wasn't a part of it. I think Bill was a dancer, in all honesty.
Really?
He was a dancer in the beginning.
It was like mid-80s or 87, 86?
80, I don't know. Like 85, 86, I was probably 14, 15 years old.
Wow. Yeah. Wow. So how did how does this happen? Jay Prince is looking for rappers, and
the crazy shit, man, is like, I remember doing a song with Beto and Bruce and Def Jam Blaster and Lil Troy called Scarface.
Wow.
Yeah.
So that wasn't your name then?
No. Oh, I did the record. I did a record called Scarface because, you know, we thought we was the shit, man. What? We was selling rocks and you couldn't tell us nothing. We had fucking 38s and we'd shoot you, you know, no big deal. Yeah, shit happens.
So that's how you got names
for real.
Really?
On life. And, we ended up doing a record called Scarface, man, and then, you know, the shit kind of spread it out wild in the streets. Uh-huh. And before I knew it, man, there was this little dude, and that little motherfucker had on more diamonds than I had ever seen in my life. Uh-huh. He had a big white two-door convertible 560 custom at my little townhouse.
Right.
I'm like, man, who in the fuck is this? All right. He knocked on the door, and we opened the door and shit, and it was Lil James.
Right. And you knew who he was prior to
this? Hell no. I heard the name.
Right.
You know, I didn't know who Lil James was. It's two different sides of Houston.
Right.
So it was the north side and the south side. Mm. And man, James came to the south side, bro. Right. And he knocked on my motherfucking door.
Wow.
So and you know, later on you hear different stories and shit, man. Right. When I really got to know James, you know, over the past 34 years, mm-hmm. when that nigga knock on your door, it's some serious shit.
Time to move.
Right. It's some serious shit. So cuz knocked on my door and I was like, what the fuck? How did you find me?
Alright.
Like, how did you find me? Man, I'm literally a needle in the haystack right now.
All right. Cause you was a dope MC. Cause you was
you a DJ too?
I was a DJ too, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
So, so he comes to your house and he tells you he wants you to be down with this group called the Geto Boys that already had an album out.
Yes.
So how did you feel about that?
I didn't want to do it.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. And then my fucking brother, man, he was in jail and called me.
Right, he was what?
He was in jail.
Uh-huh, and calling you?
And called me.
Right.
And told me, man, I heard you sounding rap a lot.
What?
Man, I'm gonna kill you when I get out of here.
Wow, he didn't like the rap a lot?
Nah, we didn't fuck with nothing. We didn't know nothing about the North Side. We've been in Houston forever.
Oh, makes sense. Okay. Okay.
Yeah, it's
so
like,
even signing to him was like a bad move. Okay. Especially for your hood, did you get slack coming back to the hood after you signed?
Nah, shit, I can't say that.
Right. Okay.
I can't say that I got slack about it. I may have heard some damn, man. You went to them niggas over there, man. But I ain't wasn't no, you know, right. wasn't no real beef about it. You know right. what I mean?
Right.
Cause we ain't really do beef too well.
So how old was you when you did My Mom's Playing Tricks on Me?
I was probably about 19.
Do you understand your verse still is relevant to this day?
I was going through some shit, man.
right.
Yeah. You know, and I tell you something too, Nori, this shit don't stop.
Right.
Like I'm always going through some shit, man. Right. It depends on what day it is. You know, like, they'll determine
they
the type
of shit. That's why
Whitney
Houston
through.
Wrote some great shit, is cause they went through some shit.
Probably more than likely.
So what the fuck was you going through when your mom's playing tricks on me? And then you're the only one that has two verses on there.
No, it was actually three verses.
Cause you wrote the whole song. That's what
that was your song?
Right.
It was. And then I didn't write Willie's part. Willie chimed in. So something that happened, I gave the record to James. Uh-huh. And it was my verse. It was and I can't sleep, I toss and turn, and day by day it's more impossible to cope, and then this year Halloween fell on the weekend. Those were all my three verses, right? And then James went to California one day and shit came back another day and shit. It was Willie on it, and you know.
Right.
It was,
and you had
it
new
was
Willie?
A big-ass record, huh?
You had new Willie prior to that or no?
Yeah, I knew Willie. This was the second record.
Okay.
That the first record was Grip It.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
But and you know, I'm kind of glad the Geto Boys got on their record.
Right.
Because it makes it that much bigger.
Right.
And that was, you know, the original beat?
Yeah, when it was your original, record. Nothing changed on the beat. Right.
Wow.
And so when I got a chance to work on my solo album, and this was the main goal for me signing with Rap-A-Lot in the first place, because I got to work on my solo album.
Right.
So I produced 98% of my whole solo album.
Wow.
So I made the beats and all of that shit.
Wow.
Yeah.
Like what you was always producing?
Always.
Damn.
I'm probably a better producer than I am rapper.
No.
Damn.
Shit. Hey, Don.
You're one of the greatest rappers of all time.
Am I probably a better producer than rapper?
Nah, man.
That's been my DJ for like the past 25, okay. 26 years. Okay. So you say what?
Listen,
like I got beats.
I'm gonna tell you. You gave me a slice of humble pie one day. I don't know. I know you don't remember this. One day I had a show with you.
I heard you tell this story, man. That's not true.
Tell the story all the time.
Yeah, it's not fucking true, man.
Yeah, this is true.
It's
listen
not
to
true.
Me.
Let it ride. Drunk facts.
Yeah, listen, I could not.
Right.
Let me tell you guys. I want to say it in front of your face because. Like, it wasn't me. It was somebody at my camp that got a little, you know, cocky, I want to say. And it was like, yo, you know, Too Short had just came in. He just ripped it and just left. So he didn't care who went first or whatever. And they said...
I got a story.
They said, yeah, so, you know, Face is coming late. So, yeah, because you're going to keep... Yeah, yeah, let the people...
I'm press. Listening, man.
So they
no,
said,
don't
Face is coming late.
I'm passing. Ryan and Scott, Jr.
So they was like, yo, do you mind going first? And one of my homies was like, nah, man, we got the platinum record right now. We going last. And I kid you not, when Scarface came out, man, and all the records that you was playing, and I'm talking about the whole audience was your hype man. Like, the audience was the hype man.
I walked out there by myself.
Yo, my dude, was you. And listen to me. And this is the killer. This is the one that really, really killed me, was... Mary, 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 Mary Jane, and the crowd just sung. I wanted to get the promoter back his money. I let yo here, take the shit back. I'm not going on after that. You gave me some fucking goddamn humble pie. Since then, I go immediately. As soon as they go, I'm going to stage. Let's go. I will never take that chance again. You know what I mean?
It's a lot of people. Like we fight. With managers all the time, because it's just I do not want to go last, and I don't give a fuck who it is.
Wow.
I don't.
Wow.
I don't give a fuck. You know what I mean? Because what I'm gonna do, what Short gonna do, what Juvie gonna do, what 8 Ball MJG gonna do, what DMX gonna do, what Cube gonna do, is they gonna beat that crowd ass.
Right.
And
right.
By the time you walk out there last, the motherfucker gonna be like
dead.
I'll give you another humbling moment. It was one time DMX had just dropped both of his albums. He was the number one dude.
Oh, fucking right.
On the planet.
Fucking
and I
right.
called you one day, or you called me with something, and DMX was literally air hustling. Because I said Face Mob or something like that. He was literally air hustling. And it was like, you smoked a Scarface? And he was so much of a fan of you. Do you know how much DMX
man,
loved you?
I think we were really good friends, man. Right. You know? Right. It wasn't... I don't think we fanned out.
Mm-mm.
I think it was just like...
I can't let you be humble on this one. He was your fan. Like, he was 1,000,000%. And he loved to say it. Nah, Face, I can't let you get away with that. I know you're a humble guy, but I can't
man,
let you...
Do me
you,
like that.
You was DMX's favorite. I'm talking about... And I said, that was the first time... This is after DMX was... He was platinum hair and platinum hair. I literally didn't think this guy was a human. That was the first human moment I've ever seen DMX is when I called you or you called me. And I was just like, yo, Face Mob. I said something like that. And he was like, you speaking to Scarface? And I was like, that's the first time I said, yo, DMX is a human. Like, I always thought he was a dog. Like, I swear to God. Like, I swear to God. But, I mean,
Did
you know how much X love you?
Man, I know how much X loved me as a human.
Right.
You know, outside of the music shit,
right.
You know.
Right.
We talked, you know, a lot. And we had this ongoing joke. When we saw each other, it was like, God damn, Earl. you done did now. Right. And then we just bust out laughing, bro. Oh,
that was your relationship? You called him Earl and he called you Brad?
Yeah, fucking
right. Because a lot of people call you Brad. I'm not comfortable with calling you Brad. I'm calling you Face Mar for the rest of my life.
Well, I'm not, come on, man.
You was running for governor of women with city council or some shit. I was still saying, Scarface, Face Mar, I'm sorry. Was
you
I supposed
to call you Mr. Jordan? That shit. Huh? I made it to the runoff.
You made it to the runoff?
Yeah, man, and I beat that lady, but they fucking cheated me with the fucking ballot harvesting, man.
What the hell is that? I don't even know what that is.
It's like when people just sign people's names. Oh, they
sign folks in.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, so what made you run for city council?
Man, because ain't nobody doing shit.
Wow.
You know, everybody see what's happening, man, and they talking about what's happening, but ain't nobody doing shit, man. We steady marching. Mm-hmm. I ain't trying to march no more. Mm-hmm. We not going to change, you know, legislation, and we ain't gonna amend the laws that's already in place. Don't make no new laws.
Right. Get in the trenches.
You know, fix the old laws that they already got in fucking place, bro. Fix that shit first.
Right.
And then start coming up with some new shit.
So aspirations for more?
I'm definitely going to jump into politics, man, because I'm tired of the ass kissing. We got all these go along, get along ass politicians, man, and I don't want to be a part of that, bro.
Right.
Like, I'm going to be totally opposite. I'm going to be against all that shit. What's in it for the black people?
Word.
You know what I mean? What's in it for the brown people? What's in it for us? Right. Like, everybody else getting it. Why don't let me have it now?
Right.
My fucking turn, bro.
Yeah. I love that. Yeah. I think hip hop should dead seriously take over politics.
We should.
Because most of these people, I think that we're scared that, you know, we have criminal backgrounds and criminal records, but most of these guys have criminal records. Didn't this guy, George Bush, are fucking criminals.
Man.
Yeah.
Criminals. Right. Not criminal backgrounds, goddammit. Criminals.
Right.
Feel me?
Right.
Yeah, they're criminals, man. Mitch McConnell's a fucking criminal. Mm-hmm. But go ahead.
No, that's what I'm saying. I really think Killer Mike should be the mayor of Atlanta. I really think E-40 should be the mayor of the Bay.
We need Luke to keep trying and Luke
to be the mayor of Miami.
That's heavy. And E-40 being the mayor of the Bay.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. I really think so. The Bay's not a city,
right? That might lead the schools fucked up, man.
Nah, man.
Earl, what's up, Earl?
Yeah, man.
I love you, Earl. Nah, it'd be cool, though.
Yeah, man, yeah.
It's time for us to...
Like, imagine Jay-Z as president, Beyonce as president.
Yeah, fucking right.
Like, I know it's something, but I just, like, that should be dope. You know what I'm saying?
Jay-Z not into politics at all.
Yeah, he's not really.
Man, I was talking to Jay-Z about doing
something. Another thing is, I posted a picture of Jay-Z the other day, and you called me.
Yeah.
And you was like, man, Hov... Is I forget what you described, Hov, but you was so passionate.
Hey, you're like, the real deal, bro.
Yeah.
But he said he was talking to Jay. What'd you say,
Jay? Yeah. Jay ain't into politics, but I tell you what, though, he is the fucking keeper of the culture.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Shit, Jay-Z chucked me a lifeline when I was on my back.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
So... Motherfuckers say anything fucked up about Jay, he gotta deal with me too.
All right, let's make some noise for that.
Yeah. Nah, Jay's solid, man.
Right.
Yeah, and DJ Khaled, another solid motherfucker, right, man. Keepers of the culture, man. Right. Jay Prince, keepers of the culture, man.
Yeah.
Let's make a real fucking put a real light on that shit.
Well, when I hit Jay and I hit Nas, Jay's exact words about you was, let me read quote for quote. Right, hold on, because I don't want to.
Jay the real deal, man.
I don't want to. I'm reading both quote for quote. Okay. Face is beautiful. Love that guy. Salute to the gods. That's what, and then now Nas said. Okay, hold on.
Tell my brother
Brad, I said happy birthday. Love him.
Jones.
So I think he thought it was your birthday.
Yeah.
And even though it's not, we're making today your birthday because you on motherfucking drink chat. So we got you a cake. We got you real live cake.
We settling here, this motherfucker.
We got you your Macallan 18, and we got you flowers as well. We'll give you some flowers as well. We going all the way with this shit. Because you deserve it. Nah, you deserve it.
I'm about to leave.
No. You deserve it,
y'all,
man.
Y'all fucking tripping.
Yeah, man. I swear to God. Nah, I said, I don't know why he thought I was saying it was your birthday, but we running with that. So I got my notes. I'm going into my notes. Okay. What happened to Bushwick Bill on the cover the hospital. And is that picture real?
Fucking right.
That picture's real. Really?
Man.
Okay.
You want some real, real shit?
Okay, yeah.
So.
So, yeah.
We got flowers.
Yeah,
we
got flowers.
Where I'm gonna put this at?
I don't know. But fuck it.
It goes good.
We just wanted to do our part of the job. You know what I'm saying? Our part of the job.
Yeah, but eat some of this motherfucking cake.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Look, so
talk about the cover.
The night before. The night before, we heard Bill got shot. You know, by his girl. And they say he got shot in the eye.
Wow.
So I had already, you know, I was already in my mind that they, you know, that was the end of that. Like, you get shot in your fucking eye, that's the end of that story. So I was like, damn. So we had to go up to the hospital the next day. And let me tell you, how, how much of a thinker James is.
Okay. James. Jay Prince. When you say James,
yeah,
talking about Jay Prince.
Yeah.
Okay.
The old man. Yeah, he wanted to go to the hospital that next fucking day when Bill could have visitors, man, and shoot the fucking album cover.
This guy's a genius. It makes sense now. But back then,
man, Bill is fucking dead.
Okay.
And Bill sit up in the gurney and Chief push him out in the hallway and Bill sitting up on the gurney. I'm talking about out of there.
On meds or because of
the on the meds. He's on meds.
Yeah, he's out of there. And got me and Willie to stand on each side of the gurney, man, like we was pushing him out the hospital saying we can't be stopped and snapped a photo with his eye hanging out and that was it.
That's like,
so that's not props.
Fuck no, that's not props.
You knew that,
yeah,
man?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
And I was like, shit, Bill finna die, man. All right.
And he's a small guy, too, so you're not thinking he got the same strength as everyone else.
Shit. Jay had that mentality. I don't give a fuck if he die or not. We gonna get this picture. Oh,
thanks for doing for that, goddamn.
Hey,
holy
shit. We gonna get that picture, man.
Holy shit. Okay, now let's go into Smile.
Okay.
Very deep, deep record. Telling people to smile. But it's still, for some reason, the record still comes across like a dark record. I guess because of the video.
And when it comes out, the timing of it.
Okay. So, let's talk about the Smile record. So, I originally did the record at the Death Row studio with Tupac.
Yeah, he's on the record, right?
Yeah.
Yeah,
okay. So it was like, I want to say that it was a record that Tupac had his crew on.
The Outlaws?
Yeah, Outlaws. And then I think it just turned out to be me and him. But Pac used to always get pissed off at me because it took so long, you know, to write. Like, I always wrote my shit. I didn't just...
Because he was just cranking records out.
Oh, Pac would do a fucking record every 15 minutes.
Right.
Yeah, he was serious about it. But it took a long time. He'd always get pissed off at me because I'd still be sitting in the front of the mixing board when he'd leave and come back. You know what I mean? I'm writing my shit. And he told me one day that, you know, do what... He say, write the shit. Don't worry about it. You got to get across to the bitches without offending them, and the niggas gonna like what the bitches like. Right. And whatever your last word is in the verse, that's the hook.
Right.
So think about it. Smile for me now. You know.
I remember me going to the studio one time and me seeing Irv Gotti playing Smile for Prodigy and saying, this is the balance that you need. You need some like, yeah, I remember that.
Oh,
like,
shit.
Playing, like, this is like, because you remember P was making so much serious records, and he didn't have in my opinion, that's why I thought Irv was trying to tell him. But I thought it was genius that he played Smile for him. You know what I'm saying? He's playing, you know, y'all record, and it was just, it's amazing. But when I go through your discography, and I'm listening for 2 days, It really felt like every time you wrote music, you was in a dark place. Is that accurate or?
Man, you know, N.O.R.E, I don't know, man. I just write music, bro.
Right.
And I go where the beat lead and where the spirit lead.
Right.
And that's just me.
Right.
I just, you know, it's almost like I don't even write it. Mm. It's just a, it'll just go.
Like automated?
Everything that's in my head just comes out on that piece of paper right there, you know? And if it's dark, then maybe it was dark. But, you know, I think that if I gave those lyrics to somebody else and they put it on another beat, then it probably wouldn't be as dark. Wow. It's all in the setting that you set. It's all about the delivery and the mood, man.
Right.
I've always been one that was conscious of how I sounded when I came on or when I finished it or, you know, the cum lines. I wanted to make sure that everything was strong and the voice that I used in that particular song matched those beats, those horns, those piano riffs, that bass line. I wanted my voice to be like let's call it like another instrument. You feel me?
That's fire.
Yeah.
That's fire.
Yeah.
I wanted, a musician.
In real life.
Yeah, in real life.
In real life, like I was born to musicians.
Right.
My whole family, musicians, all of them.
And
everybody.
You knew how to play the guitar. That's
I
you
play all that shit.
You learned that shit or you?
I mean, it was just given. It was like a God given right,
play the
bro.
Piano? Get the fuck out of here. What school you went to? Juilliard?
I went to the fucking Willow Ridge, man.
Listen, so we got some people that we checked in too, right? Look, we got some people that checked in. We're going, let's go to this correspondence. We never did this before, but you a person that deserved this. So we're going to give you your flowers for Rigadelia.
Hey, who got a knife to cut this cake, man? Is this a real cake?
Yeah, it's a real cake.
Mr. Lee made it himself.
It's nothing fake about you.
It's a Dominican cake.
Nah, what is in here?
You got it?
Mr. Lee made it. Mr. Lee.
Lee, what's in here?
Nah, he bought it at Publix.
Cut this motherfucker open and it be red. What kind of cake is this, for real?
It's vanilla.
Vanilla, yeah.
Yeah, check it out. Check it out, face.
Oh, man, don't do that. Yeah, I can't eat it. If it's something else, I don't want it.
I think it's just vanilla.
Yeah.
What y'all got back there in the styrofoam?
What up, OG Thugger checking in, you know what I'm saying?
Hey,
yeah, for my boss partner, you know what I'm saying? Face Mob. Man, what Face Mob is, the Slim Thug, man. Wow, you know what I'm saying? The pioneer, you know, y'all had the East Coast, y'all had the West Coast. I'm coming from Houston, though, man, the bottom of the South in Texas, man. So what him and Jay Prince did by him being that lyrical and that good, to having the East Coast, West Coast, the world respecting his rap, you know what I'm saying? For him opening that dope fuzz, it made it a lot easier for them to give us that game, you know, without even giving it to us, just showing us how to do it. It made my whole life a lot easier, man. And I definitely look at Face as the GOAT, you know what I'm saying? And got nothing but respect for him, and I tell him every time I see him, you know what I'm saying? But I wonder, my question is, do he think he get the proper respect from the game, you know what I'm saying? As we look at him as a top, you know, dog in the game, do he believe that he get the respect he deserve in the rap game? That's my question.
I mean, respect. Do I get the respect that I deserve? Slim had a, he got a mean question there. Slim, fuck. I call him Granddaddy Pimpin.
Okay.
I mean, it's kind of like you really don't have to respect it. But you're going to have to. You know what I mean? You ain't got to show it, but you got to respect it. Because. Bunny.
Oh, I got a drop from Bun anyway. Don't worry about it.
What's up, right, buddy?
We don't need you to interrupt the show no more, Mr. Lee. Please. I'm flowing. I got this all together.
Goddamn buddy.
I got Bun on the drop, too. Yo, what's going on, bud? Word up.
Hey, buddy, I'm on Drink Champs, man.
Are you drinking?
That makes Bun happy. Yeah, but shit, you know, I'll be asleep 3 days after this.
But tell Bun we hit him back because we want to finish this.
Bun, we're going to shout you back,
yeah,
love.
We want to finish this.
No, y'all do y'all thing, man. Love y'all.
Love you too, family. 1,000.
So I'm trying to understand, are you saying yes or no? You saying you do feel respected. I mean, you have to feel respected from your peers, from the other players in the game. You got to know how much people really respect.
Oh man, it's all love, you know.
Right.
And I never really looked at it as getting respect or none of that shit, cause right. you know, just invite me to get on the record, and right. you'll be like, oh shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like fucking. It's like the devil walked in the room right. when this nigga get on this record, cause he the real deal.
Right. Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like you, games. If you didn't respect me before you got me on this record, right. you will.
Right.
Now I want some DMX shit though. You will. You know. Yeah, because my what's on my mind, especially if like it's a if, like if it's up in the air, mm. like who the nigga is when I get on this motherfucking record with you.
Right.
Like we gonna go ahead and do it. Okay. You know, it's like a nigga racing cars or a nigga fighting dogs. Like it's about to go down.
Right, right.
You know.
So hit that, Ross.
Look at Pauly, man. Look at Paul, man.
Big salute to the triple OG Scarface.
He gave me too many O's.
Hey man, thank you for everything you done did for hip hop, especially what you done did for H-Town Texas hip hop, man. I got a question for you, man. Hey, of all the Houston rappers that ever came out of Houston, or let's just say Texas in general, who is your favorite Texas rapper of all time? Your favorite Texas MC? It could be somebody old school back in the day. It could be somebody new that's just not coming out.
I can see your face right now. You don't want
to MC of all time, man. Big salute, baby. Yes, sir.
You know what? When you ask me, when you ask me who's my favorite rapper to come out of Houston, man, it's gotta be all of the ones that came behind me, man. From fucking right. From Zero to
UGK came after you as well, right?
Yeah, but UGK from Port Arthur.
Okay, all right.
So it's a difference.
Okay, yeah, that's
Devin
right.
It's and Odd Squad.
But you got Devin, you got the Odd Squad, you got K Reno.
Devin, we
came around
chess.
The same time. You had Romeo Poet, Willie D. Slim, you had Paul Wall, right. you got D-Lo. Who am I missing, man? Like, it's a lot of dope-ass rappers.
You just want one, though. Come on, let's just get one.
Kyle. Okay. You got a rapper named Killer Calion. That's a bad motherfucker.
Killer Calion?
Yeah. You got A-Leaf 360, Neighborhood Kells. It's a lot of them. It's too many. Mm. It's too many. Like, they got, you know, the UBK movement. They got some real spitters on their shit, so it's just it's like we lit a fire, and then they never got a chance to put it out. So it's just ongoing.
All right, let's hit that next one.
Yo, so shout out to Peter Rosenberg. What's up, EFN? What's up, N.O.R.E? Question for Scarface. Well, first of all, let me be clear. Scarface is one of the absolute greatest who's ever lived. I've told him this, and I'll tell the world this. Growing up in the D.C. area, Geto Boys and Scarface were so iconic. Like, we were not late to the party in this area when it comes to Scarface. We've been down forever. And I'm sure Face will tell you he always did real well in D.C. My question is, though, where do you rank the Fix among your bodies of work?
That was
and
my question.
Was it different? How different was the process for you being at Def Jam? Did it make it a different process for you? Because I absolutely love that album. I think it's nearly perfect. And I'm just curious to where Face... to how Face thinks of the Fix. But seriously, Face, you are one of the greatest ever. By the way, if y'all haven't checked out his autobiography, his book is incredible. Your voice and writing is good. Yo, with a guitar, he's nasty. He's just one of the all-time greats. Love, Face.
Let's make some noise for that, goddamn it. But now, the Fix is one of my favorite albums in your catalog. I got it up there as one, so I'm curious to where you have it.
I have never even judged it
wow.
like that. I don't know, bro.
Really?
It's like I was making music, you know.
So you don't have a favorite album?
It's like the time, and that's what was going on in my life at that time. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, I will say this about the Fix. Like, I had a lot of fucking help, bro.
Wow.
So the process
this,
you
this
felt
is this is you at Def Jam, and you are the president as well?
Yeah,
you're the Def Jam.
But I had
Def
a lot of help.
And when you say
man.
You had a lot of help, what you mean?
Like, I had every fucking producer that you can name.
Right.
Phone number in my Rolodex, you know.
Yeah, but I wouldn't call that help. I would call that making the album.
Like, yeah, no, nah, but you know, like for the previous albums before that, I was responsible for making the beats.
You know? Yeah, this is the reason why I wanted to do Dream Cast, because you're fucking Scarface. They're going to give you the best beats that they fucking make.
I don't know who the fuck those people are. Right. I had no idea who those people were.
Right.
You know what I mean? I had no idea how to contact them people.
Right.
But it was like the...
Because I imagine me being the producer, me walking in the building, they saying, who's the sister with? They saying Scarface. I go straight to the best bunch of beats.
Yeah, nah.
All time. That's me as a producer. That's what I would be doing.
Like, I've always worked with Joe... Tone, Beto, you know, Mike, and I was, you know, 95-96% responsible for the shit that came out.
Who these producers you worked with on the fix?
Kanye's on there.
Kanye, I worked with. Knots. Yeah. I'm fuck with Kanye, Knots, Pharrell. Who else, y'all?
Come on.
Anybody remember?
Come on, ass.
China Black.
Wow.
Mainly it was Kanye, though.
Right.
No, not Mike Dean. Mike Dean didn't do nothing on that album.
Thanks a lot, Hass.
Tony Bizarro.
Nasheem,
Nasheem, yeah.
Wow.
Who else? Mike didn't do nothing but mix that album. He didn't touch nothing. He didn't produce nothing.
China Black.
China Black. Yeah, keep going.
T-Mix.
T-Mix, yeah. T-Mix and Kanye had. Yeah, T-Mix got some big records on there.
So, yeah.
No,
never heard of him. What's his name?
L-O-F-E-Y.
Oh, Lofi, yeah. I don't know what Lofi did, but yeah. No, maybe. I can't remember.
It's Tony
Bizarro.
That's awesome.
So the reason why The Fix is one of my favorites, and it might be political, it was like you came to Def Jam. You were the president of
Def Jam at the time.
I was on Def Jam.
I worked the record because I was a Def Jam rep out here.
It was just like you actually, without telling us, you showed us again that a album means something. Right. At the time, everybody is in,
everybody trying to make singles.
As the era is
like
still,
a full body of work.
It's all about single. That The Fix was from the beginning to the ending,
down to the packaging.
I wouldn't have it no other way.
Right.
I wouldn't.
Right.
I am. I'm serious as fuck about it.
Right.
Okay. Uh-huh. Like the way you see it, uh-huh. The way you hear it, uh-huh. You know when you hear it.
Right.
The shit that's leading up to you hearing it, like I'm gonna fucking set you in the fucking chair, bro, right. And you're gonna watch the show.
Right.
You feel me? Like you're gonna watch this fucking show. Right. Oh God, what is? Oh, and then you're gonna hear it.
Right.
Like I'm gonna have you so ready to hear this shit.
The setup.
It was great about set your ass up.
You was on a Def Jam. It was the Leo Combs, Kevin Lyles, Julie Greenwald, Mike Kaiser,
fucking right.
Randy Acker, Rob Love, Sam Cresco. That was
Tina Davis.
Tina Davis. How the fuck did I get? So sorry, Tina. She's over there at Empire doing her thing right now too. But you had the real stat. Was that like the first time you felt like a major was behind you, or you felt like that prior? Because I felt the major was behind you that time.
Man, I've been with rap a lot all my life, bro.
Rap a lot is independent.
Yes, yeah, independent. Okay. But you know, Jay made us believe that any fucking thing was possible.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Right. So if I could go platinum, you know, on an independent,
right. Then
shit, if a major could take me triple platinum,
right.
Quadruple platinum, then we doing something. You feel me? Mm-hmm. But if a major can keep me where I am, then I'm just where I am. I ain't moving around.
Right.
You feel me?
Right.
So, I just felt like I had a lot of help, man.
Okay.
And I had a lot of people that knew shit, you know, mm-hmm. about the music industry that was around me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I had a lot of experienced people around me. But thinking about and looking back on everything that that I learned and I saw at Def Jam, mm. I already knew from the little independent label that I came from. Mm. You know, we worked a lot harder. Mm. You know, we worked hard as fuck to get that label to where it is.
But
I mean, it was about the same. You know what I mean?
This was crazy, right?
No, but what, was that supposed to be the first record to set off the Def Jam South?
No, I think Ludacris
was the first.
Was it?
Yeah, Ludacris was.
Yeah, Ludacris.
So when you came in, you brought in Ludacris, right?
I did. Yeah, no, when I came in, I wasn't. You know, it's a funny thing, too. Like, all of the down south artists that shine like fuck, from Rick Ross to T.I. to David Banner to Lil Flip to all of those kids. Like, I, Paul Wall and Chameleonaire, I tried to bring them to Death Jam South, bro.
Wiley.
Whole life.
Wow.
Yeah.
And they fronted on them?
But what was Death Jam South exactly? Like, what was it? Because at some point, it didn't seem like. It just folded into Def Jam.
Yeah, I left. I left.
Was it a real thing, or was just a
name? Yeah, it was. It was pretty dope.
And it was pretty dope. I had my own. Right?
No. It was Todd Moskowitz.
Todd Moskowitz. Okay, yeah.
It was Todd and Leor that put it together, and then Kevin. You know, we worked together.
Right.
But
and then Khaled later on took it over, right?
I was way going by then.
Yeah, later, right?
Yeah, but it was always big, man. I had my own staff in Atlanta. It was, you know.
Oh, so you had headquarters in
Atlanta? Yeah, I had everything. Okay. It was cool. And then I couldn't get Haystack signed, bro. Like, couldn't get Tripp signed. But Haystack was a big old white boy out of Tennessee, man, mm-hmm. that really mm-hmm. fit the Def Jam South description, man. And he was dope, you know. I couldn't get that signed. I couldn't get Tripp out of Florida signed. You got an artist out here by the name of Triple J calling Fresh Dope.
Wow.
Motherfucker's fucking awesome.
Wow.
Yeah, Google that shit. Put that shit on your must hears. And his name is Fresh Dope. Check it out.
Okay, so on my block, that's one of my favorite singles of all time. It's probably, I would say, one of your brightest records. But still, the subject matter, you chose that for your single, right? Oh, they chose it.
They chose that shit.
They chose it.
Yeah.
You didn't. Well, the way you said it. Don't tell me you don't like my block.
Crazy.
Oh, you hurt my feelings right now. Please don't say that. Really?
My shit was, I swore to start a small time dope game, pushing on the corner, 50 cent cook up, 50 flippers if you want them, full of formaldehyde, my clothes reeking marijuana, cops rolling up on us, my neighborhood like a sauna. That kind of shit's my single, but go ahead,
Nah, man, so wait a minute. So you make my block. Def Jam comes to you and says, this is the single, this is the one?
I think that might have been Kevin Lyles, bro. I think everybody, you know, in Def Jam, like we had this thing, man, called Everybody Had to Be in the Boat.
Okay.
So I think that everybody got in that boat, and they picked that one.
But hold on. So I need to understand how this meeting happens. You're not feeling this?
I mean, shit, I'm a ride with them. Niggas the majors.
But, no, but what I'm saying is, cause this hurt me. I love that single. I would have thought you single handedly made that for us.
You know what? I'm not a radio single dude. You feel me? Like I'm a street single. I love the fucking streets.
It's true. It's like saying you don't hit doubles, but you on the Yankees now. Now you're on the Yankees. That's not your forte hitting doubles, but you know you can hit a double with this one. You didn't feel like that at all? Damn, face, you hurt my feelings. Yo, for real. Damn.
Man, I love the fucking streets, man. I don't give a fuck about that radio shit. No. Because you know what the radio gonna do?
Right.
They gonna play your shit and then they gonna be gone. You know what them streets gonna do? They gonna play your shit forever. And they gonna play your shit and they gonna play your shit and they gonna play your shit.
I agree.
I don't fuck with that radio shit,
but
man.
But they're not turning off the radio neither. I didn't turn off my block when it came on. I turned it up.
I don't even know if they played that. Did they play
it? Yeah, they played it.
Well, you know how I feel about the radio, so I'm gonna stay in my lane, bro.
Wow,
that's a great.
I would have never.
That's a great.
Let's get some more people. Wow, you. I would have never thought that, bro.
Totally against radio. I'm till I die.
Right.
One time for the OG's OG.
Turn it
my
up,
my big brother. my mentor, my confidant. I love him so much. He's been so much for me throughout my career as well as my personal life. And I'm so glad that the Drink Champs are giving him his flowers. My brother, our brother, the illustrious Mr. Scarface himself, Brad Jordan. I love you, big homie. But I would love for you to talk about on Drink Champs when we all went to Freaknik that year, when everybody went to Freaknik, when you had the yellow Lamborghini. Talk about that weekend, big homie.
I have nothing to say.
Yo, I am so curious because your face just did a different turn.
I had a Ferrari. It was yellow.
You fucked every bitch in
that. I wasn't there. You
I can't, just yellow Ferrari.
So, like back then, you know, you take a picture at the car, on the car from the dealership and shit, right?
Uh-huh. But you don't drive away in it.
Yeah, no.
You drove away in it.
I've been gone.
Right.
So I drove my shit out to
Atlanta
for Freaknik one year.
Uh-huh.
92?
Four?
Four?
Wasn't that the last year of Freaknik?
94?
Okay.
Maybe 94.
And they was bossing, I think it was the last year that they freaked me out.
And they was busting it wide open?
That shit went down. I mean,
it went down?
I wasn't down with it.
Uh-huh.
But it went down.
But it went down. Let
me dig it.
Let's give him some more McAllen, man.
No, I know how to, man. I'm a professional.
Okay. Good. So what went down? We have no idea what you're talking about.
Shit, we had a good time. We had a fucking blast, man.
A fucking blast.
Yeah. But you know what? I didn't. I kept my pants on.
Okay.
I kept my pants on. I kept my pants on.
Okay. All right, I get it where this is going. All right.
Even in the shower.
Even in the shower. Okay. All right, here, let's get another one. This is a funny one, too. I'll say this one.
Face Mob, what up?
Turn
it's
up.
Your boy, Saigon. And I want to first salute you, legend. Second, I got some questions, man. Being you are part of the legendary Geto Boys group, there's a rumor going around that my man Willie D knocked out Melly Mel, man. First, I want to know if it's true. Second, I want to know, was you there to witness this? And if you was, how'd you feel about seeing your partner knock out a fucking pioneer like that, man? Melly Mel's a pioneer, man. Anyway, God bless, man. Get back to this training. Salute, Face Mob, Scarface, Geto Boys, hat or day.
Okay, I've never heard this, Face.
I've heard this story.
You've heard this story?
I will let Willie tell his own story.
Okay.
But I will say this. Don't you run over Willie D talking with that bullshit.
Y'all see Willie D being he.
Nah,
like,
I don't
like
even matter.
Jitsu, right?
That jiu-jitsu. Yeah. Shit. Ask Melly Mel about that ninjitsu or whatever the fuck you said. I knew you was going to do that.
Jiu-jitsu. Yo.
Shit. I heard that Willie D beat up two people that day.
Really?
Yeah. But I let him tell his own story.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah, we need Willie D on here.
Yeah, we need Willie D on here.
What's the first tour that, first national tour you went on?
Public Enemy.
Mm.
Latifah. Jazzy Jeff, Fresh Prince. Fucking Naughty by Nature. Apache.
Damn. Rest in peace.
Tribe Called Quest and Leaders of the New School. Yeah.
Man, that's a crazy ass.
Fuck.
No, Leaders of the New School. With Busta Rhymes.
That's the first national tour?
Yeah. I can't remember everybody on that shit. Man, let me tell you something, man. Like, all of those tours, man, like I was cool as fuck.
Right.
Like I was always cool, man. I'd be in my room. I don't, you know, I'd come out with my brother, I'd come out and we'll go get something to eat, go to the mall, some shit like that. Mm. I don't know what Willie and I do know what Bill did. Like, Bill was the epitome of what you would call a fucking rock star. Mm-hmm. You know, because he would thrash the hotels, he would throw the TVs out the window.
He could pick up the TV?
Man. Bill was a fucking rock star.
Wow.
You couldn't tell him nothing, bro. You couldn't say, Bill, don't do that, bro.
Till the end,
don't
too.
Don't fucking do that, man. He a fucking face. I don't give a fuck, face. Fucking everybody wants to be fucking gods. I don't give a fuck, face. God damn, Bill, that's a $2,000 motherfucking TV you just threw out these people window, man. I don't give a fuck. You know, Bill, he don't give a fuck. He didn't give a fuck, man. He, you know. You know, Bill, like, that was my little dude, man. Like, he would always walk faster than I could. So looking at him from behind, you ever seen the movie Big? I fucking laugh, man.
That's the way you just said that. Wait a minute.
You ever seen the movie Big, bro? Yeah, he just looked like my friend just shrunk down and had on like he was cool, man, like Tom Hanks was in Big. Like, he just got small, you know? And he got small, man, but that little bitty dude, he was smart as fuck. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And he was probably the biggest asshole in the world, bro.
Wow.
For real. Like, ask anybody. Yeah. Like, Bill will come and spend the night at your house and leave 2 or 3 weeks later, man, cuss you out, eat up all your food, smoke up all your dope, tell you fuck you. Be at somebody else's house next week. You know, Bill didn't give a fuck. Like, you had to love Bill, bro.
Wow. Let's get another one.
I miss the shit out of Bill, man.
Turn it
up. Mr. Scarface went running down the block. Out came the gauge and he shot up all the spots. What up, Young Gotti? Scarface in the building. History, West Coast history, Southern history, and the South, icon. You know, I gotta keep this game straight, man. You understand me? Gotti Heffner in the building. You dig? Telling this game real quick. Face Mob, East Coast history. You understand me? Mr. Scarface. Love you, Unc. You know what I mean? I got a question for you. Coming up in the South, out in Houston, what can you tell these people that's trying to come up from the South, out in Houston, Dallas, all surrounding areas? What does it take, man?
All that patience. That's a good-ass question. You know why?
All this you learned being in the streets, going from the streets to the
streets. You know what makes that question so fucking dope and so fucking real? It's because we wonder why our artists don't make it past a certain point on the map.
Meaning local artists?
Right.
Okay.
And I always thought that we kept it too local. Mm. You know, we rapped to impress our city. Okay. You know what I mean? Yeah, man. I'm gonna give me some elbows. I'm gonna pull up at motherfucking Papa Do's and
Papa Do's is one of my favorite restaurants, man. Seafood Yala, let's go. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But if you ain't got a person as well versed like you, you know, and they from somewhere that ain't got no Papa Do's, they don't know what the fuck a Papa Do's is.
Exactly.
If I tell a motherfucker that, I pull up at Timmy Chan's and they like, what the fuck is Timmy Chan's?
Right.
But that's the Houston restaurant.
Hey, y'all was the first one drinking scissor too, right?
I don't fuck around. I don't fuck around.
Okay, continue. Papa Do's.
Yeah, don't fuck around.
Never fucked around with scissor?
I mean, every now and then, you know, back then in the gap, I had a sip or two, but it's just not my type of hype.
Baby.
The last thing I want to do is be moving slow.
Right.
You know.
Wow.
I'm sure that the first record that came out about Sir came from out of Houston. But I just think that we gotta go a little bit deeper on our subject matter. Mm. And that's that, and that, and that's how we'll get to that next level. Okay. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Like, we can't rap for our homeboys no more.
So that's what you answer Corrupt's question.
That's the answer Corrupt's question. Okay. You know, I think that everybody, we should rap not only for our homeboys, but we should rap for our homeboys in Miami and my homeboys in Cleveland, our homeboys in D.C.,
right.
Our homeboys in Chicago, homeboys like in South Central.
We made the war report. Our slang was just Queens. Our slang was just Left Rack, Queensbridge.
But motherfuckers in New York picked up on that shit. The Harlem New York. Picked up on
it. Yeah, but I didn't think Houston would appreciate up on it. Ate it. Let's go to another one. Let's go to big homie Ice-T.
Oh, that shit, hey, that's up, my man? OG like, right
what
there.
What up, brother Mob? It's Iceberg, man. You know, your motherfucking nigga, man. Represent, man. I just want to let you know, man, how much we love you, how real you are, how much I am inspired by you, how your lyrics are some of the few that make sense and mean something, you know? And we talked before when you dropped Deeply Rooted, I'm like, man, the only way I might get back in the studio and do an album is if you produce the whole goddamn album. I think that would be dope. I'm building a studio in New Jersey right now, so let's get it, man. Stop playing. N.O.R.E. called me today, said, Ice, man, let's give Scarface some love. I'm like, that's not a problem. I'm in the car right now, you know, waiting on wife to come from a run. Look, I got Chanel in the back. Say hi, Chanel. I'm on my dad bullshit today. But love is love, man. From one G to another G, man. Scarface, man, love you to death, man. And who knows, man? Maybe an Ice-T Scarface project produced by Scarface, you know. Of course you gotta drop some bars. That might be the way to go. You know?
God
that might
damn.
Be the dopest shit ever.
Are we breaking grounds? Is that first of all?
Can that happen?
First of all, I don't remember hearing y'all. I got a record together, right?
I don't think so.
Damn, I don't remember. Just I'm gonna be honest. When he said that, because you know, I just called everyone 10 times. I didn't care before. I have no pride. Just so you know. So I called everyone 10 times. Like, yo, make sure they do it. And when he said that, I literally chills went throughout my body, and literally watching it again, knowing what's about to come on, still equally chills still came through my body. Did you ever know that?
Man, like, you know, my when I first met Ice-T, man, Ice-T took me up to the hills of his house, bro.
Should that open up? Okay.
And I was fucked up. You know, I was like, wow, man. Like, people really do live like this. Mm-hmm. And my dream, that was another segment of my dreams, man, to, you know, he showed me some shit. And for Ice-T to say that, and like I say, bro, that's my big brother, man. That's the OG, bro. Mm-hmm. And for him to, you know, want me to do his project, like, I'll fuck Ice-T's album up. Because I'm a fan.
Right.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? It's easy to work with people that you're a fan of.
Right.
Because you know the direction that you would want to hear them go from there.
Right.
So if I ever sat down at the new studio that Ice-T's building in New Jersey, and I did his record, I'd fuck it up bad.
In a great
like,
way.
Like, yeah, like it'll probably be the best record that Ice-T's ever made.
Woo, I believe because so.
I'm gonna fucking do that.
Tiger Woods
I'm
right
such
now.
A big fucking fan Tiger of Ice-T, Jaru bro. Woods.
I don't know why he looking like Tiger Woods in here. Jaru.
Who's that?
It's Jaru.
Oh, Lord.
Because everyone know you a golfer, so the people want to put on golf suit.
Yeah, like Jaru don't want to play me in no golf.
I just want to send a lot of love to my brother Scarface, man. One of the most influential rappers in history of hip hop.
Damn.
Definitely in the South. Definitely trendsetter in the South. and in hip hop period, musical genius, plays several instruments. Yo, I just want to sit in your flowers, King. Love you, Face. You know how we do, my brother. And I'm going to get your ass out of the greens real soon.
I knew he was going to say that.
He's looking like Tiger Woods.
Like, I'll kill Ja Rule, bro. And that's my partner, too, man. But he be come out there, man. I want to fucking smash him, bro.
You serious about golf?
No, shit.
All right. First of all, he had a question?
No,
that wasn't no more questions? Okay. All right. You're from Fifth Ward, right?
Not from Sunnyside. South Park. South okay. Acres.
South Park?
Like South
Park?
Acres, yeah.
There's a real place South called Side. South Park. Really? Yeah. Holy shit, yeah. I didn't know.
South Park, right. Sunnyside, South Acres. It's like so right there.
You from there, how the fuck do you get introduced to golf?
My little girl kicked my ass at golf. She was 14. And she was hitting the ball right down the pipe. It wasn't going there, for she was taking lessons.
Right.
And she was hitting it right down the pipe. Uh-huh. And I banged that motherfucker up, everywhere. Uh-huh. So she'd always beat me.
You talking about your little girl, you talking about your daughter, obviously.
Yeah, my
right?
daughter.
Okay, good.
Yeah. But now, nah.
You fucking with, Charles Barkley and Jordan and them?
She 28, and she don't want to see me. Charles Barkley don't want to fuck with me. At all.
I'm talking a lot crazy, man.
Yeah, I'm talking real slick on Charles. Charles don't want to fuck with me at all.
And you called him Charles just now?
Chuck Beagley is what I call him.
Okay.
Yeah,
I can Beagley. Go with that.
Beagley don't want to fuck with me.
You know, one year you called me, you told me to sign up to a golf tournament or some shit, but I had to know how to play golf, and I was just like, Face, I suck.
Yeah, no,
I've never played golf.
Yeah, ever. No, you don't want to fuck with me either.
You challenging me, I'm telling you, I don't know how to play. That's how you know you're competitive, too.
You can't play.
You don't want to fuck with me, no. I'm Face,
hey, what's that?
You a competitive dude. I can tell you ain't playing when it comes to golf.
No.
So how did you just you like golf? How did this happen? You drinking coffee one day and just said, fuck it.
I took my little girl to her golf lesson.
Oh, yeah, you said that. Okay.
Yeah.
And but you wanted, man, to beat her.
I just wanted to play.
Okay.
But man, you hit like 1,000 fucked up shots and 1,000,000 fucked up shots. Uh-huh. And then you finally hit one, bam, a good right. one, and make you come back the next day.
Right.
So.
You ever played with OJ?
I don't fuck with OJ.
Hey, man, OJ asked me to play golf one day. I had to think about
OJ
it.
What's his handicap?
I had to think about what's it, man. OJ it's handicap? The juice still. It's still a rip, though.
I don't give a fuck. What is his handicap?
I don't know what that means, handicap. That's like,
okay. Okay. I tell you who I'll fuck with.
Okay.
I'll fuck with anybody that play golf except for Tiger Woods.
Okay.
Everybody on the pro tour, I don't really want to fuck with them yet.
Okay.
But, I mean, I ain't going to fuck with Michael Jordan. Mm. Clyde Drexler can stand on the motherfucking freeway and hit that bitch all the way to land in the Bahamas, so I ain't really trying to fuck with him. But anybody else can get it.
Okay.
Fucking Mark Wahlberg, I'll fuck him up. Come on.
I've seen him play. I've seen Mark Wahlberg play golf in Entourage, not in real life. I've seen him play. Yeah.
Okay. Pretending for real.
Yeah, like whatever.
So what celebrity have you played in golf?
Joe Torre, Cedric the Entertainer. I played a few comics in golf. I fucked them up.
So you beat Joe Torre, you beat Cedric the Entertainer.
Phil Ivey,
the real golfer?
Phil Ivey.
Oh, who that?
He's a poker player.
Okay,
yeah.
Right.
He can play golf, though.
Okay.
But I'll fuck him up.
Okay.
It don't matter, bro. Call them. I'll fuck them up. Mm. Go get somebody. I'll fuck them up.
Right.
Except for Tiger.
Yeah, I wouldn't call Tiger. No.
Yeah, that's probably your only. That's probably your safe bet.
Tiger.
I might not be able to fuck him up, but with his leg hurt, I'll fuck him up.
Right.
So I'll fuck him up.
Now. Golf is a long, long game.
I know, and let me tell you something too, N.O.R.E. But
you can get high, you can smoke,
I don't want to get high. Yeah, I mean, want to gamble.
Like I'm saying, if I was to smoke a blunt while I'm smoking,
you gambling? Wanna,
you gonna frown on me?
Fuck with me? I'm gonna kill you.
Oh yeah, I'm not trying to be high. You don't want to be high.
You don't want to be high.
You believe me?
Last thing you want to be fucking with me on the golf course is high.
Because I always drunk. See people smoking cigars and they also drinking.
Go ahead.
No, that's not it. So it's not like bowling. Because they say in bowling,
I don't give a fuck.
You smoke and drink more, you get better at strikes.
Go ahead.
That's not like that in golf?
I don't know. But you don't want to be drunk or high because I'm going to fuck you up.
And he going to take your money.
So you don't smoke cigars or nothing when you do it? No Macallan?
I don't want to hear no music.
Why?
I don't want to hear no kids and shit playing. Turn your fucking phone off and let's gamble.
Right.
Yeah.
And that's about gambling. It's not about... It's about gambling for you.
Man, we finna gamble. I'm not finna go out there for nothing.
Right.
Shit, this is hustle.
All right, so
I walk out there, act like I don't know what the fuck I'm doing.
Mm. So you got the glove and everything?
Like Mike.
And what are you, a righty or lefty?
I'm left-handed, but I play right-handed.
Okay, so you hit this way.
I hit the same way you do.
Okay, I'm right-handed. Jesus, I don't want no beef. I don't know. He's still
sizing you up.
Size that nigga N.O.R.E. ass up. See, ladies, that nigga he ain't start moving slow. Nigga checking your ass size.
We got another one?
Yep.
Oh, shit, this is great.
Face Mob.
Oh, shit.
What's going on, baby? Just wanted to tell you much love. Send you love, King. Let you know how much we respect you, how much we love you, how much we appreciate you.
Oh,
all your classics, all the great songs you've written and everything you've done for the culture, everything you've done for hip hop, baby. So I wanted to just, you know, give you some love, you know what I'm saying? And wish you the best, baby. Love you, King. Peace.
Goddamn!
Oh,
by the way, LL was on vacation with Magic Johnson and Samuel L. Jackson,
oh,
and
shit.
I hit him. I FaceTimed him. I said, yo, bro. I said, yo, I need to make face.
Oh,
give him his flowers. Fuck. And he was actually, it was him and them. I don't want to say who else send the videos back to first because his video ain't playing. But this is what I'm trying to tell you. You know what you mean to hip-hop? Like,
I got an LL story.
Oh, let's go. Let's please, get into please. It. Let's get into it. This is what we here for.
Fuck, I'm going to try to say this shit without fucking breaking up.
Okay.
Damn. Mm-hmm. LL has always been there when it was a groundbreaking moment for me.
Wow.
Everything I love, bro.
Wow.
When my career first started, I was at the New Music Seminar in New York.
Right.
And I got on the phone with my mama at this club. And LL ain't know me from no motherfucking body, bro.
Wow.
And I say, LL, that's my mama on the phone. Can you say hi? Man, LL picked up the phone, bro.
Look.
And talked to my mama and shit.
Right.
And bro, blew the fuck up.
Wow.
The next time that LL...
But he blew the fuck up or you?
I blew the fuck up.
But you wasn't nobody.
He was already blew the fuck up.
But he knew you was Scarface when you handed the phone.
Had
no
fucking idea.
Oh, it's a moment.
Okay, I get what you're saying now.
One of those moments.
Okay.
And then that next moment, bro, is when I signed my deal with Def Jam.
Wow.
LL came to the signing party, bro.
Wow.
At the hotel called The Time in New York.
Wow.
When I first signed with Def Jam. Yep.
Wow.
Yeah, and on a few more occasions, man, I get a chance to see the L, but, you know, he called and wished my grandmother a happy birthday like that and shit. Like, oh. LL is just a super solid ass dude, bro.
Goddamn, make some noise for LL. You ready for another one, Ross?
I got a good one for you.
Go ahead, let's go.
I got LL phone number in my phone, cuz.
I ain't gonna lie, I got Derek Jeter number. I'm scared to use it.
Oh shit!
Just don't know what to do. Let's get some more ice. Give him some more McAllen too,
bro.
Give him some more McAllen too.
I don't want no more McAllen. Yo, pour this out and give me a fresh one.
Yeah,
bro.
Give him a fresh one. Yeah, play.
Hey, give that to my brother, man. Thanks. Yeah,
man. As I walk into the studio, dude, it's my jig. I got a phone call from one of my niggas. He said my homeboy Reed. He just lost one of his kids, and when I heard that, I just broke into tears.
Cool
salute, Face Mob, Scarface, one of the greatest MCs in history, spanning decades of greatness, whether we talk about Geto Boys, whether we talking about classic records with Pac, Hove, you know what I'm saying, as a kid growing up, Scarface was always the one you listen to when you want to hear that real, you know what I'm saying? Man, it's an honor for me to even be sending this message out to you. We salute you. We celebrate you.
Damn.
Face mob forever. Salute.
I want to give a big, big blessing to my brother.
Let's keep it going. Let's keep it going.
The icon Scarface. Scarface, Face Mob, you already know how we do it. We family. You know what I mean? I just want to thank you for everything you've done for us.
Nah, thank you, homeboy.
And you've been doing for us and everything you're doing for us now. We love you. We appreciate you. You top five. Straight up. You one of the greatest that ever did it. Lyrically. Not even just that. You special. And you my brother. And I'm honored and I'm proud and I'm excited that I can call you my friend. Face Mob. DJ Khaled, love you. You know that. It's on everything I love.
We're so noise for that, goddamn.
So Khaled, like
I love
I say,
that I'm choking you up a little bit.
Yeah,
like,
I'm loving this,
just so you know. Cause
that's why I don't fuck with you no more.
Because you deserve every flower. You deserve every, like, and I for all time I've always knew you. You've probably been the most humblest person ever.
Yeah, you fucking me up.
Yeah, but I just want you to know, like, even though you're humble, even though you're a great guy, this is the reason you deserve these flowers. You really mean the world. Like, I see people how they talk about you when you're not around. I see people how they talk about you when you're around. I see people just praise. And this is the first time I thought of this. I said, you know what? I was like, you know what? You know, let's just hit a couple of the people and just, you know, get some videos. So you could really know, because we made the phrase famous on this show, giving people their flowers. But I wanted to literally give you flowers.
Yeah, you fucking gave me cake, too.
And I gave you cake because it's your birthday, too, now. That's your birthday now, too. But these videos meant so much because, you know, for the most part, I didn't have to twist anyone's arm. Even though I said it earlier that I made, like, 10 calls, I was really just bluffing because, really, from the first time I called, motherfuckers just send over video. And I just want you to know how much you really, 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 really loved in this motherfucker. Because today, you're going to leave here knowing that how much you mean to motherfucking hip-hop.
I'm actually pretty fucking mean, but yeah, it's all good.
Yeah, okay. Hold on, I got. You have something to say?
He saved it.
You got another one? Okay, let's go. I was going to save that one. Okay, yeah.
That's a good one.
Okay.
This is
turning it because he's talking low.
Oh, yeah. Jay Prince coming at you live and in living color. What's up, Face? Man, I'm hearing that you on Drink Champs, and I wanted to stop by because I believe I done tapped into the fountain of you with this loyalty. As being said, you have represented the name loyalty to the fullest. Even in the midst of the feds putting a full court pressure on you to lie on me to try and convict me, Scarface stood strong like a man. I salute you for that, my brother. Now, there are some things that I want you to know about this big word called hip-hop. Hip-hop love you. And I would start with the East Coast. You was DMX favorite artist on the East Coast. Now I'm going to travel to the West Coast. You was Tupac's favorite artist on the West Coast. Now I'm going to go down South. You was my favorite artist.
Oh, fuck.
And with that being said, we want you to know that we love and respect you. And I also want you to know
shit, that's live.
Good around the world love and respect Scarface because they understand that Scarface laid the foundation that all of hardcore hip-hop stand on today. Salute you, my brother.
Now, some of these I couldn't look at because I wanted this reaction. I wanted me to be just as surprised as you.
Yeah.
So, yeah, like, the next one's gonna fuck you up. Here, hide it so you can't see it.
So, nigga, so.
We keep going.
When Jay.
Uh-huh.
Say, yeah, nigga, you was my favorite artist. Like,
that's hard.
That means something, because you don't like nobody.
he said that nigga ain't everybody. He said that on here. Wow, man. Yeah,
that means something. When your brother love you, that's a good shit.
Hell yeah.
All right, where's my boy at?
Let's get one more going.
Wait, let me get my boy in here.
Okay, yeah, get that McCallum.
What?
They finished it?
Talk about my shit, nigga.
Y'all met my son?
Yeah, definitely. That's my boy. Gabby, we're going to got another one to play for you. Go ahead.
Whew. Oh, shit. Don't play that one.
Yeah,
good. Hold on. Don't play that.
Ooh. Big Daddy Kane.
Nah, don't play that one.
Yeah, come on. We got to play them all, man. We got to play them all.
No.
Come on.
Before you play Kane.
Okay. You got a story?
Fucking right.
Oh, let's go. I love how you wrote that.
So, Kane is by far, like, probably the most influential outside Ice Cube and Chuck.
Wow.
Like, I'm a fucking hybrid.
Right.
Between Ice Cube, Chuck D, and Big Daddy Kane.
Mm. Mm, I can see that.
Yeah, no, you can hear that.
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah.
Okay.
I wanted to have that fucking
flat top.
Not the flat top noise. God damn. like Big Daddy Kane was skillful, man.
Yeah.
And he had a delivery, and I wanted that.
Who flat top rules in 89?
What up?
I'll fuck Kane up with the flat top. I don't even worry about the flat top.
Okay.
So he had that delivery, man. Mm-hmm. And he had lyrical skill, bro.
And he fucked Madonna. Allegedly.
I don't think he fucked her, bro.
Oh, yeah, that's right. He said he did. He just like, I forgot.
He might have laid in the bed with her.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Finger pop or something.
With his pants on. Yeah. He pulled another like me. Yeah, he took a shower with his pants on.
Give us his pants on.
So Kane had the delivery, bro. Mm-hmm. And he had the lyrical fucking professionalism that was unmatched, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
I like Chuck D. Because Chuck D had a mean-ass fucking voice.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You know? And then Cube told a mean-ass story. So I wanted to lyrically have a mean-ass voice and tell a mean-ass story. Lyrically, Kane.
Mm.
You know, with a mean-ass voice, Chuck, and Cube tell a mean-ass story. Mm-hmm. So I'm a hybrid between those three MCs, if I say so myself.
That's a super MC.
Let's see what Kane had to say.
Hey, yo, Face, what's good, man?
Turn
it's
up.
Your boy, the BIGDADDYKANE. Just here to spread some love. And thank you for always being a real dude and a real lyricist. Because you made something from nothing. And vowed to never tear it apart. And turned the street hustle into an art.
That would
I ain't gonna
quickly
mess up
change
lyrics.
Life forever.
That's when your
songs
keep me down. And you never let them keep you down. Stay winning. Respect.
I love Kane. Kane did my one of my high school reunions, man.
Oh shit!
Really?
On Everything I Love, bro. He did one of my high school reunions. Class of 90.
And you went to the reunion?
I performed too.
Oh, okay, that's fine.
Right. And one of those rare occasions, Kane opened up for me.
Really?
Shit, that was dope.
Really?
So since he recited one of my shits, I got to recite one of his now. Mm. Kane said, my rhymes are so doping, the rappers be hoping to sound like me so soon I'll have to open a school of MC
for those who want to be it.
If I feel the core, but then again, second thought, to have those MCs coming out sounding so similar.
It's quite confusing.
It'll be quite confusing for y'all to remember the originator. Man, Kane was a bad motherfucker to me, bro. Let it roll. Hold on, man. Don't clap yet. Let it roll. Get bold. I just can't hold back the fold because I'm the man with soul. Put the groove in the feck and what the heck? Rock disco texture. This groove is the next.
I love how humble you are. So we keep trying to give you flowers. You keep trying to give other people flowers. We're going to stop you from now.
Flowers all around.
It's about you today.
Hey, Marley Marl and Dr. Dre. is probably is the influence on my production though. Mm. Yeah, for real.
That's great people to be influenced by.
Thanks, bro.
That's great people to be influenced by. Let's hit another person. Let's look at that. Big boy.
Face, what up, man? It's your partner, Big Boy. Big Boy's Neighborhood. Let me tell you, bro. For one, this is crazy that they hit me up to do a video for you, man. And the reason why I say it's crazy, Face, is because I'm a fan. You know what I'm saying? I'm a fan. There's people that are like peers and things of that nature. And I know you don't really trip off of, you know, being the best or telling people how great you are or things like that. And I don't even think you understand how amazing you are to us. You know what I'm saying? So when they hit me up to do this video, first off, I was like, man, they drink champs. Are they drunk? No. But no, just being on this show and being able to say this to you is I'm humbled and I'm honored. And I've had so many years of listening to Scarface, bro.
Wow.
And a lot of ups and, you know, some down moments, bro. And you have really gotten me through a lot, bro. And I've introduced so many people to Scarface, man. Even when it wasn't the so-called, you know, popular thing to do, you know. But nah, I've been rocking with you for years, man. And, you know, we always talk about, oh, man, we got to give people their flowers. We got to give them their flowers, bro. I'm telling you, man, I don't know if we get you. It's not a vase or a vase of flowers, man. I think, hell, we got to get you like an extreme flower garden, bro, because you've done so much for us, man. You've given us so much joy, bro. And I really love you, homie. And I'm just honored to be here, bro. I remember Fast Times. Selling dope wasn't my pastime. Life in the fast lane. While counting cash, I sit back and wonder.
Who will be coming me?
See the beamer coming. And then they run to me. Hop out the vehicle.
Yo, what you need, bro? I need a nickel bag of weed, yo.
Make the sale, then I bail out. Now it's time to
get the hell out. Every day was the same thing. Dope fiend thing. Me, big crack act, because I sold cane mainly.
Out of the bigger, had the biggest.
Rocks on the block.
Get out your money, dig this. Come on, bro.
He went back to my first shit.
That's dope.
Hello, flowers.
You can let the next one go. There's only one.
Hey, yo, I want to send a big shout out to the legend himself.
There he
Face
is.
Face Mob, my brother Face Mob, Scarface.
What's up, guys?
Councilman Brad, what up, man? Much love, much respect, man. You're a legend in the game and really don't know what hip hop would be without you. Love, bro. And oh, what up?
There he is.
One more, right? Yeah.
Mm.
Ooh, they
go that boy. Yo, what up? Hey, I want to give a shout out to my big bro, Scarface Face Mob. We make a great combination, don't we? Face, I want to give you flowers while you still here, big bro. I love you. I thank you for being so instrumental in my career and allowing me to be blessed to have so many records with you and just, you know, being a part of history, you know, and I love you for that, man. I remember when I was first doing my first album, The Truth, and they asked me, you know, who I want, you know, as features on an album. And I was like, Scarface. And they asked me again, like, who else did I want on an album? And I was like, Scarface. Because I ain't want to do no features on my first album. I wanted to be just me. But on my bucket list, if, you know, I had to do features, I was like, man, if I couldn't get nobody, I'm on Scarface, man. And I love you for that, and I thank you for that. And from there, we did so many records together, man. I love you, Face. Big bro for life, man. Face my top five in my book, early. And I think N.O.R.E. should do the remix to My Mind and Players Tricks on Me. Yeah, I think he should remix that. Because he thinks mind is tricks on him. If he thinks that he can rock with me on a verse, it's N.O.R.E. Let's get it. It's on. And no, I love you too, bro. Let's go. Let's go. Let's ball.
Come on, son. That's it? You ain't got dabs? Dabs, yeah. We got, oh, damn. You got dads. You're missing. Yeah. If you look at your shit. Yeah. That was fine. Hold on. Let me play you dads.
That nigga dads. That nigga dads, bro.
Dad was the first person that sent.
That boy Dad said, I'm in the world on my own. I move on. I got to stay strong. No matter the fuck with us, your fucking life gone.
Yeah, look, Envy, and then I'm going to play you, show you guys.
Shout out to the Drink Champs. I just wanted to send love to one of the greatest in this industry to do it and that will ever have done it.
Fuck.
I mean, you're a legend. You're an icon. What you've done for Texas, what you've done for hip-hop, you're a lyricist, and you continue to grow, you continue to evolve, and you continue to be great. You know, we love you on the Breakfast Club just for who you are, and we just want to give you your flowers and just say we love you. And Scarface, you're one of the realest. No matter what it is we ever ask you for anything, you are there, no matter what it is. And there's not too many people in this industry that's like that. You're a stand-up individual, and we will continue to support Scarface, the legend, the icon. We just want to give you your flowers. Salute.
That was Envy, though.
Huh?
Love Envy.
Can you put up the Daz? We play the Daz, then we're going to get into this quick time with Slime. You're going
to
love it.
And what shout out to the Organic Food Kings.
And big up to Organic Food Kings.
And Organic Food Kings.
You know what I'm saying? Getting that organic food.
No shit.
Yeah. Yeah, you got some girl over there.
Fuck.
Oh, let's do E-40 there. I sent you okay. Dash.
Hey, what, Earl? That's Earl?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Oh, yeah, Gilly too, yeah.
Look here. This for Brad Jordan, man. You know, Scarface. It's your boy Earl, man.
What's up,
you know,
Earl?
We call each other Earl and Brad. You know what I'm saying? Hey, bro, I just want to, you know, salute you for your longevity, your long career, for being in the game many, many years ago. We are both OGs, bro. I love the way you put it down, bro, you know, with your storytelling. The Ghetto Boys work to Never Seen a Man Die. I mean, it goes on and on and on, man. You are truly one of the GOATs, and I salute you. And keep going, my dude, and we love you. You know, 40 Watt, I love you, man, you know. People don't know, Brad picked me up from the airport, all kinds of things. We go back to 1992. Come on, man. And it's still my guy. Shout out to Rap-A-Lot. Brad, we're giving you your gardens. We're giving you your roses, your flowers, everything right now.
How come everybody put on a golf outfit?
Earl, my dog, man. But if he ever come out there on them greens, I'm gonna crack his ass up.
Yo, what's up, y'all? It's that nigga Daz Dillinger representing Drink Champs. You know what I'm saying? Giving it up for my homeboy Scarface. You already know, man. Mind playing tricks on me, Ghetto Boys, the whole nine, man. I appreciate you. I love you forever, always. That nigga forever. My gangster book, DA to the Z.
Right, boy.
Motherfucking right.
Let's get Gillie in here. One more.
Oh, that's my nigga, man.
You already know you're a fucking legend. The legend of all legends, you hear me? That's what I'm talking about, baby. I grew up listening to you, looking up to you, and admiring you. You know what I mean? For being a G you was, I appreciate you. All love from the whole Million Osworth Gang family. Right.
My nigga.
You see how much the industry fuck with you, though, Face?
Man, I fuck with the industry, though. Right. You know what I mean? Like, bruh, it couldn't have been... Like, this made my fucking day, bro, for real.
We
like,
tried to, bro.
Like, it's moments that came about, I was like, oh, shit, I ain't gonna be able to get through this.
All
right, yeah. Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. But, man, I got through it, and...
It's the first time we ever did this. Like,
yeah,
like,
yeah, it's kind of cool
this episode to be special. You know what I'm saying?
It's kind of cool to be loved, man, by your peers, man. Yeah. You know. And Slim asked that question: do I feel like I get the respect that I deserve? Mm. And I think that my peers showing me love is all the today, respect I need.
Today showed that you...
Yeah, that's all the respect I need, bro.
I'll make some noise for that. So hold on.
Before you go, you going quick time?
I had one more question, then quick time. But you going
to
say something?
I just wanted to play some for him real quick.
Okay, cool.
But go with your question, and I'll have a second.
All right.
I'm ready, actually.
Okay, go ahead, go.
Let me just pull it up. I'm lying. Oh, yeah, here I am. So, I'm going to tell you right now, every time they ask me for my top five, I can guarantee you on Drink Champs, you're on my top five.
Right. No shit. Right.
And in 2015, I did an album that I always wanted to work on. And I had this record that Premier produced for me. And you were the first person that I wanted on the record, and you got on the record.
I got on it?
Yeah. I'm going to show you the record. I'm going to show you the verse.
I did?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Oh, your son got on the record.
Maybe it
but
was.
But I had these vocals from Guru that he did for a mixtape for me. And that's why that record's special to me, because it's the closest thing I was ever going to get to a Gangstar record. Having Premier produce it and cut up vocals that Guru did for me on the hook.
What the fuck is this?
You. I don't know.
What is it?
Uh-uh. He said it's a hard ass record.
Right there. Here's the first verse on it.
Like that. Who's crazy? DJ Scarface, like, I ain't never heard this. Look at his face.
You're blind to what you don't see. Ignorance is blissing. Them niggas gon' be mad as fuck when they wake up. How much of our time will it take us? It's like the 60s all over. Catch a nigga sleeping, Peter Roller.
Yo, when those like vocals came in.
It's crazy in the hood, but I am not scared. It's evident that the evidence that was captured on the cameras irrelevant. Get the dogs, get the tanks out. Fuck a nigga, blow his goddamn brains out. Same shit, different city. I'm rebelling, that's the reason that they fucking with me. Wise up to the plot. They targeting the youth and just about to wipe our ass out.
DJ EFN.
It's not that impressive.
Wait, what did you say? What did you
say? That impressive. It was all right.
Wait, you're not a fan of yourself?
Man, I'm so much better than...
Are you in your own top five?
Fuck no, man.
See, that's the problem. That's the problem.
Damn, Face, you gotta have a talk.
I mean, you know what? You know what? Bro, you want to laugh right quick?
Yeah, yeah.
But nigga, you know what I think about when I think about my career? And nigga, you got away with one.
Like you got over on folks?
Nigga, I got away with one.
Okay, I feel like that too. But you're not supposed to think like that.
I got away.
No.
Nah, you crazy.
Man, I'm not really all that great, bro.
Yo, Face, come on, man. Stop. Now, I know, you know what the crazy shit? I know geniuses think like that. Like, I know you're really a genius, and some people think like that. I get it. But there's no way you can have a record with Big, excuse me, Nas, Jay-Z, Pac. Did you ever work with Big?
On the duets?
On the duets.
I didn't work with Big, but I knew him, though.
Okay.
You know, it's fucking Nas and fucking Jay, man. Mm-hmm. Those guys.
Lyrical giants,
yeah, they really make you dig into... whatever you have to find something to, you know, be in the same room with them. You know what I mean? To be in the same, to be on the same page with them. You know, they're just that great, bro. Like, and Nas did a record, man, where he raps the shit in reverse, man. That made me mad. Yeah. You know?
That made you mad?
Yeah,
you
it made
that?
Me mad. Like, fuck, man. Can we live? You know?
What?
You know, Jay-Z got a record, man.
Okay, listen, we love Nas and Jay.
Oh, yeah, today, man. Jay.
We talk about Brad, Jordan. We talk about Face, motherfucking Mob, Scarface, Mr. Scarface, Ghetto Boys. It's all about you to motherfucking Jay. And the only reason why I brought them up is there's not a lot of people who have records with them both. There's not a handful of people who can say, I met Tupac. Tupac respected me and was his favorite artist. Jay Prince said, you was Tupac's favorite artist.
Let me give you a line.
Uh-huh.
Motherfucker, Pac says, more money means more litigating, more player hating, got a sale at the pen for me waiting. Mm. It's just my fate. Miss me with that misdemeanor thinking, me fall flat, never that too much tequila drinking. We all that. See, I love that kind of shit, man. Man, grab me some drink, bro.
Deflecting again. We're gonna get you. Listen, have you ever watched?
Jay said, I hear motherfuckers saying they made hoes. Made hoes, say, okay, so.
Make another hoe. Have you ever saw The Office Space, the movie? You ever saw Office Space?
I saw it, Mike Judge, yeah.
Did you not see when they took it out on the fax machine?
They should have.
That's the best scene in cinematic history.
It is?
In my opinion, when they set it off on the fax machine, they go and they playing, what song are they playing of yours?
No, they're playing Die.
No, it's Damn
playing
It
Die.
No, I'm pretty sure it's Damn
It Feels
Good.
I can almost guarantee you the song.
Damn It Feels Good when he's driving in the car.
Oh, okay.
Still, B.
Okay.
Oh, it's playing Still. You said something then.
Yeah. So, do you know this movie or how does this happen?
Like, I don't know.
You didn't know.
I had no fucking clue.
You had no clue?
I just seen my shit on there and it was there.
Check came in.
You also in one of my favorite movies too, where you play Double Dose of Pimpin'.
Yeah, Idiocracy.
Idiocracy. Do you know that's what's happening right now, Idiocracy?
Mike Judge. It is. It's Idiocracy. Like, people, he called that shit.
The more technology is giving us, the more stupid that we're becoming. Like, I don't even know. I don't definitively know my mother's number.
Like, for real. I don't know my mama's phone number.
I don't know my mama's phone number. Like, but I dial mom, and it comes up.
Yeah, I don't know nobody's
like,
phone number.
Back in the days,
number.
I knew my mother's number because
you knew mad numbers. You knew mad numbers.
Like, do you believe Idiocracy is a real thing? Like,
it is, man.
Uh huh.
It's cold-blooded, too. Right. We have no clue what we have done. We want to make shit so easy until we're not using our brains no more. Mm-hmm. We're not thinking no more. It's like, oh, shit. That is.
Yeah, it's our brain.
What was your name in the movie? You was a pimp, right?
Yeah, I was Upgrade.
Upgrade with a double dose of pimp.
For the double dose of my pimp.
Let me finish this Ace of Spades. Oh God!
I actually did a good role though, in Irv Gotti's Tales.
Recent, is out already?
Yeah, I think really? I did pretty good in that one.
Yeah, Irv ain't talking to me. Yeah, I've been calling him for a couple weeks.
Really?
It's okay. We're friends. It just happens like that. Queens people, it just happens.
That's that Queens.
Yeah, it's Queens. Shit. No,
yeah.
I hit DJ today though. So you into acting? That's something that you're into? No? Face, you ain't into shit.
Just golf.
Just go with the flow.
Chilling, man.
Just golf.
I play golf, and you know me and Willie did a podcast.
Oh, yeah, I got a podcast.
I'm Black Effect.
Black Effect Network,
we played the trailer on our audio.
Oh, yeah.
Y'all should fucking chime in.
Yeah,
follow us.
We'll be guests, too. No problem. What's the name of your show?
Ghetto Boys Reloaded.
Ghetto Boys Reloaded. Make some noise with Ghetto Boys Reloaded. So what made y'all want to do a podcast? And do y'all interview guests, or is just y'all interview yourself?
No, I don't want to talk to Willie about nothing. We interview guests and we have a good ass time. It's not as fun as this, but it'd be cool though.
Right.
You know, it's pretty fun.
Right.
We interviewed Mike Epps and
really.
We interviewed. I like talking to regular people. You know. I talked to a sex therapist. I talked to a sex traffic.
Sex trafficker?
Sex therapist and a sex trafficker?
That's why I'm not coming back. Listen again. Let me break this shit down. I talked to a sex therapist.
Who was a sex trafficker?
No. Here's the sex trafficker. This the lady.
They calling you?
She just fucking called me out of the blue.
That's crazy.
She on the line.
Hello? Hey, I got you on another podcast. Say hello to N.O.R.E. and FN from Drink Champs.
Yay!
Hello.
Huh?
How art thou?
What?
How art thou? Since this ain't our holiday, unless you want to call
the sex
it
therapist the sex therapist or the sex
therapist? The trafficker. This ain't my holiday.
The rehabilitator, bro.
What's going on, people?
Hey, Aunt Kathy, I'm gonna call you back.
She got real.
It's very important, okay? I got some news for you.
Okay, baby, I'll call you back, honey. Give me about 30 minutes.
I love you.
Love you too,
baby.
Yep. Peace out. So she's a hoe rehabilitator.
She an ex-hoe. So she been hominated.
But she's, you know, no, she works with prostitutes and gets them rehabilitated.
Is she a housewife? Because is it true? Can you turn the hole to a housewife?
Shit, that's beyond my.
We don't know if she's a housewife.
You got an egg.
Because you
ain't got nothing to do with Junior.
You never know. Okay, so listen.
I'm in my lane.
This is a part of the show where we give you multiple choice. If you go pick one or you pick the other. If you pick both, we take a shot. Being that I don't think you're gonna take a shot. But I think we're gonna let your son come in. And your son, would your son take the shot for you?
No, he gotta work.
He gotta work?
Hey, DJ B though, I got somebody.
You gonna have your homie? You gonna have your brother? You gonna have your homie step in?
I'm gonna let him drive.
Alright, cool. Who, the son goes to do it?
No, I tell you what.
Okay.
Both my son and B over take a shot. Come on.
Okay, cool.
Come on, Chris. Right.
Come on. Yeah.
Well, you want a shot? You got a shot circuit
like
motherfucker.
Or
you been smoking
dope?
You
got the
whole you. So now remember.
Nah.
Chris, you been smoking dope?
Yeah. Okay, where's it at? I gotta look for it.
I'm not drinking that shit.
Hazardous? All right, cool. So anytime he says both, then y'all take a shot. Alright.
Hey, don't drink that shit, Strut. Don't put no fucking take no shot of that shit.
We can use the rock. Where's the Ciroc at?
I don't want no
clear
shit.
You want
what you been drinking right now?
Look, we got brown Ciroc.
Brown?
Yeah. We got brown Ciroc.
Here's your shot.
Yeah, and I'm gonna do
What you want, B? I'm
gonna just sip it. I ain't even
gonna. No, don't do that yet. Don't just pour a little bit.
And I got Ciroc. I'm gonna do my whiskey. I'm gonna do my whiskey.
Hey, put some rock right there.
Ain't regular. Yeah.
There you go, B.
All right, so you ready? So remember, one or the other face, if you pick both, then they take a shot, all right?
Both.
All right, cool.
Both.
Up, rip?
Both.
Hold on.
Open this shit up, though. Open it up, though.
Open it up. Yeah,
both.
Open. Okay, so, okay.
No, all right. Both.
All right.
Where's this cup?
All right. All right, let me at least ask the question, though. But I know you're going to go for both for this one.
Hold up. Both.
Okay. Okay. All right. Nas or Jay-Z?
I just told you.
Okay, look, right, give him a shot then. I'm going to join him.
Yeah, we're going to drink too.
Right.
All y'all motherfuckers drink now, both.
I'm going to drink. Thanks a lot.
Salud. Just that whiskey. So they got?
Yeah, we already drank.
But they already drank? Okay, all right.
Yeah, you late.
Ooh, that whiskey shouldn't be taking us a shot.
I told you not to take it as a shot.
Just, God damn it.
Okay. Major or independent?
Indie.
Okay, you ain't got a good shot for that one. Big Mike or Willie D?
Willie.
That was a good one. This one, I don't know where you're going to go with it. Tupac or DMX? Both. Shot.
That motherfucking bottle at.
Okay.
You taking your whiskey again?
Yeah, man.
You wildin' out.
I'm already here with it. You might as well.
Cheers.
Fucking, I'll do that on both.
Both? Okay. Salud. Okay. I know where you're gonna go with this.
Where yours at, Beto?
I'm right here.
Yeah, okay. Rap a lot. Or Def Jam South?
Grab a lot.
Okay, that was easy. I think this one is easy too. Look at the next two. Oh, no.
Both.
LeBron or Jordan?
Fuck. I'm out of that one. I ain't got nothing to say with that.
You got
to
take a shot.
That's both.
Yeah, neither is a shot as well. Yeah, neither is both. Yeah.
Man, no. Because let me explain to y'all why y'all both taking these shots.
I love that you give it an explanation. I love it.
Because Jordan did it first, man.
Right.
And it's like everything that comes behind Mike is like, you know, you like Jordan top tier, and if you can get up to top tier, then you made it. You feel me?
Right.
Like Kobe, you know, he made it.
Right.
Like he was there, and LeBron, like he made it. He there. So
okay.
Yeah, all y'all motherfuckers got a drink.
Okay.
To LeBron James and Michael
Where's
Jordan.
Where's your shot,
Norman? Oh, shit. Come on.
Everybody got a gun.
Another one.
I want the niggas in the kitchen to drink, too.
Okay.
Okay. You got a shot for us?
All right.
Both.
You ready?
Both. Hey, what are you drinking?
Mama Juana.
Both.
I already did. Both.
Okay. Jay Prince or Tony Draper?
James. But I grew up with Draper, though.
Suge Knight or QC? From Quality Control Music, the Migos, Lil Baby. So obviously Suge Knight.
I mean, so say it again now. What am I? Suge Knight or QC? No. I want to know, like, which one you saying? Which one, like?
Like, yeah, which you relate more to? Which you identify more with? It doesn't matter.
CEO.
Yeah, City Girls. You said City Hoes?
CEO.
Oh. So you just said City Hoes. I'm like, City Girls. Just calm down. That was all.
You know, Suge was in position to be the fucking biggest independent record label ever. Which he was, yeah, no? But I think that there was a lot of shit that happened that didn't allow him to move into that position, man. You know, it's just a whole lot of other shit that just jumped up. So I'm gonna go with QC, man.
Okay.
Cause I don't, you know, wow. he not out there with that crazy shit, man. And
okay.
You know, I like it quiet like this, bro. Go get you some motherfucking money, man. Feed your artists, man, and let's go from there.
Okay, so radio or podcast?
I don't know yet.
That's a fair answer.
Yeah, that's fair.
I'll take a shot to that. That's a fair answer.
Okay, podcast.
All right, cool.
Podcast.
Okay.
All right, well, we need to find somebody else to take a shot.
All right. The homie. With the reggaeton glasses.
We need another one.
With the reggaeton glasses.
Those are reggaeton glasses right there, baby. Those are Daddy Yankees right there.
Anybody.
All right.
Come on, man. Don't be acting all shy and shit.
Come on, Eric.
No, listen. All right, come on, Face. All right, so Bushwick or Pimp C? Both? Both? No, you gotta have your people. Hold on, that's my people. You can't be with my people to get drunk. You got your people to get drunk.
They already drunk.
Hold on. Take your fellow.
They already drunk.
Get
he's already drunk.
No. And yeah. Hey, he's driving. You gotta relax.
He's driving.
He's driving.
It don't matter.
It's your people who gotta take the shots.
Call him an Uber.
You got a shot?
Cool.
They got shots. All right, hold on. All right. That was...
We drinking this one?
Okay, yeah, I'm drinking. Okay, UGK,
both.
Or A-Boy MJB?
I said both.
How about you got to do another one, sir?
I'm riding.
All right, well, get your ass out the way.
Yeah.
Come on, let's
see.
All right, woo. All right.
Hey, can he just have a shot on GP?
Yeah, he might as well just drink
No,
Eric.
No, it's your people that gotta drink. He's driving.
Come on,
you can't deny him asking him that.
No, he's driving me. You ain't gonna deny him.
Never mind.
He's driving me. I don't wanna die, Scarface, please. Okay. UGK, you said that, right? Or 8-Ball? Okay, Biggie or Big Pun?
Big.
Okay, that was fair. Okay. DJ Screw or DJ 5000 Watts?
Fuck. Both.
Let's go, baby.
Let's go.
Jesus, okay.
That's Michael 5000 Watts. He's playing on aisle all 5000 Watts.
That's what that means.
that's the wrong rest shit. You're wrong.
No,
you
gotta pull that shit already. Back out. Play the tape. I drank my shit already.
And he can't have nothing, right?
No, he's dry.
Nah, he's
dry. Anybody
he's
else back there have something?
No, this is about your people.
All the motherfuckers ain't driving.
Look, if they not with you, they can't take the shot.
I'm not driving.
Your people gonna take your shots.
No, all the people in there with me.
They ain't with you. They with me.
No, all the people ain't with you.
That's nothing to do with this. That's nothing to do with you. You with him? He's driving. See, we can't. I don't give your driver a shot. You want some marijuana? Shit got real, right? Yeah. Okay. Loyalty or respect?
Both.
Jesus Christ. You know I'm taking a shot too, right?
I don't know if you do that. Like you taking shots.
Nah, I'm taking whiskey. I ain't gonna lie.
You better fill that motherfucker back up then, because everybody both. Both. All
right.
Both. B-O-F-E. Both.
Now you cheating.
Queen Latifah or MC Light?
He gonna say both, man. Both. Come on, God, man.
It's him. Ain't me.
And you know what? Hey,
you wanna listen to us? Just you. Hey,
on some real nigga shit?
Uh-huh.
Man. Like, I love MC Light, bro. Ever since I was a little kid.
You still got a crush on
like, that was my, like, that was my girlfriend when I was a kid. Word. In my mind.
In your mind, you was double dutching?
Fucking right.
You was doing double dutch with MC Light?
Right.
Different type of double dutch.
Different type of double dutch.
Yeah, so, yeah. So, I'm a, I love
so it's light.
Yeah. I love Latifah, man. She fucking killed that shit, man. But Light is going to always be my imaginary girlfriend, so you don't have to drink today.
Okay. No way. All right. All right, I don't understand this one. Fifth Ward Boys times Face Mob. Or Face Mob.
Face Mob,
Face Mob,
bro.
The group.
Okay, okay, cool. All right. Nicki or Cardi B?
Man, that's tough because Cardi B is funny as fuck, man. She is a... she the real deal, man. Mm-hmm. And Nicki the real deal, too. But Cardi B the real deal, man. And she funny than a motherfucker to me.
I love the fact that you went with the funny.
No, she's funny as fuck, bro.
Yeah. Because you know one of our funniest MCs of all time, who I got my funny from, Biz Markie, is fighting for his life.
Yeah, that motherfucker funny as hell, dog.
Yeah, Biz Markie's funny in real life. I wanted to play, man, Biz Markie.
Yo, you should and, have, you should cool. have, you should call Daddy-O and have Daddy-O do the impression of Biz Markie, bro. That shit is funny as fuck. And then we'll call Biz on the phone, and they both be talking like each other. Man, Biz, man, damn.
Yeah, Biz fighting for his life right now.
And, for real, bro.
Yeah, this is what I'm hearing, and all the people are reporting that he's already passed away.
He ain't passed yet.
I
hate that, you know, our people
not even say yes.
have to be
not
like
passed.
The first. I want to be first. I want to be first. Right. And the people are reporting something that's not even really, you know, true. I hate that. But
when I got sick, man, really, really sick, man.
Recently with the COVID?
With the COVID and shit, yeah, kidney failure. Mm-hmm. You know who would call me all the time, cracking fucking jokes, man.
Wait, because hold on, before you say that, because I felt like you said two different things. It was COVID and kidney failure, or it was both?
Yeah, at the same time.
Oh, wow. Okay, yeah.
I'm supposed to be dead, bro.
Wow.
Like right now.
That's why I was hitting you every day. I don't know if you remember that.
I remember everything. I appreciate that too, N.O.R.E. You called me, but you wasn't calling me cracking jokes.
Yeah, I would hit you every day.
You just checking on me, man. Yep. I appreciate that.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Yeah, but Biz would call and he would be cracking fucking jokes, man, having me dying.
Wow.
Biz sent me beats, and he'd be beatboxing, bark, a skunk, a face. You know, beatbox, you know how you do that shit.
Right.
And making his raps and shit.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. And damn, Biz.
Yeah. So, and then we won't get back into that a little
I got a point. Picture of me and Biz when I was a little kid and Cool V doing like this.
And Cool V.
It's funny as hell. Yeah, I was a little kid. Can we show it?
Please.
Oh, yeah. But in the meantime, let's answer these.
I'm out of the Nicki Cardi conversation.
Miami or L.A.?
Both.
Man, we're supposed to pick Miami, bro.
Okay, fuck it, Miami.
All right, cool. We're going to let you get away with that. Okay, now this one I really want a dead serious answer on this one. J. Cole or Kendrick?
That's a toughie.
So? You are going with?
I'm going with all of them.
Okay, all right, cool. That's both.
Cheers.
In Scarface language, that mean both.
Hold on. I don't know, but I know that them little niggas got something.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they really got something, bro. Like, they super really got something.
Yep.
All right.
You see how young I was on that picture? I couldn't have been no more than 16. Maybe 15.
Can you send that to us?
So you with the flat top? You really did have a flat top. You wasn't playing.
I told you I fucked Kane up. I wasn't bullshit, man. I fucked Kane up.
Oh, you got to send me that, please. Please send me that. Please send me that. Oh, my God. I didn't really know you really had a flat top. Oh, that's why you say you fucked
you
him up.
You see my shit fucking Kane up.
Your shit was almost flat top half Gumby. Like, your shit is different.
Hey.
Okay. DJ Khaled or DJ Drama?
That ain't a good question.
Good. Because you're going with who?
I got to go with both.
Okay.
Jeez. I know they're going to be mad at me and drunk.
Yeah, man.
Okay. All right.
Both.
All right.
Stop it.
I got the next one.
Both.
Cheers, y'all.
B-O-F-E, both.
All right. Both. Prince. Or Michael Jackson?
Prince.
All right, that was good. Thank you.
Thank you. You said who we went with? Prince?
With Prince.
Okay.
I need to ask. Okay. This is the last one.
Both.
You need to relax.
I don't even give a fuck what the question is. Both.
I just got to ask it, though. Kanye or Pharrell?
You got to say both. Mm.
Man, that nigga Kanye was a fool. Mm-hmm. Man.
Even during the Trump era?
He still is.
You still fuck with him even during Trump?
Man, I don't give a fuck about none of that. Man, I talked to Kanye when he was...
Making America great?
I talked to him, take the politics out of him.
He's a genius, musically.
I talked to him when he was supposed to be off his rocker or whatever, man. And there wasn't nothing wrong with Kanye, man. Mm. No.
Right.
Like, I think Kanye is just... expressing himself in a different way than everybody else would want him to. You know what I mean?
He's the richest black man in American history, right?
Yeah, hey, shit.
He's supposed to be a little crazy, right?
That's like, crazy.
I ain't gonna lie.
Man, let me tell you something.
That would drive anybody crazy.
They say too much of anything will kill you.
Uh-huh.
Well, if I get me $3 or $4 billion, I'm gonna die. I knew he was gonna do that.
Oh shit.
Man, I wanna do all the shit that I couldn't do when I didn't have no motherfucking money.
Alright. Mm. Alright, so
wait, was it both or is it one?
I'm gonna have to go with Kanye, and I love Pharrell to death because he's fucking incredibly dope.
I ain't want another shot. But in your lyrics, right, you say, obviously I was going through your lyrics.
Don't say it wrong.
I'm gonna say it. I wrote it wrong. But you said David Duke's got a shotgun, so why are you mad? Cause I got one.
Why you get upset? Cause I got one.
A lot of people at that time. Now I understand your analogy when you spoke about you being Chuck D influenced. Back then, when I heard David Duke, I didn't know what David Duke was.
He was a Klansman.
Fucking yes. Right.
Yeah. So when I heard you say that, I had to literally go out there and do research. Like David Duke is just don't come up in black. You know, school, or like, you know, when we was out. What? Now, I think I know this answer because I think you touched on it earlier when you said that if you put Chuck D, I think you said Big Daddy Kane, and I forget who else?
Ice Cube.
Together. What made you want to touch on that? Like, you named the leader of the Ku Klux Klan. Like, I had to go, it wasn't Google back then, but whatever it was equivalent to Google, I had to do that because I wanted to know what you meant by saying David Duke got a shotgun. Why the fuck you get mad?
David Duke,
which is crazy. I never thought we'd be talking about the fucking head of the fucking Ku Klux Klan on fucking
but he's trying to go mainstream too.
Something.
Uh-huh.
I had to give you something. I had to give the people something, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we can talk about how great we can rap, how bad my car is, or how bad my fucking diamond is. But if I ain't giving you one to grow on, bro.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Then I'm just saying words. Right. And anybody can put words together.
Right.
But imagine if somebody put words together that can make you think about, who the fuck is David Duke? And then you, the Grand Dragon. Well, that was one of the Ku Klux Klan. Yeah. Oh yeah.
And didn't he run for like?
Yeah, he was. Hey, so he that's what I'm trying to go mainstream. He tried.
And I think he was the governor of Louisiana, bro. Yeah.
And you know what's crazy?
He tried to pretend like he wasn't even with the Klan.
This is what I'm trying to tell you. Your lyrics then still matches up now. Do you know he was the first person to come out and support Trump?
I'm sure.
I mean, that's, yeah.
Like, that shit was like...
Both of them motherfuckers are Klansmen, bro. They fucking Klansmen. Like
Trump's father was a Klansman.
Fucking right. Wasn't he? You better fucking know it.
Yeah.
Really?
What?
I'm thinking you're just saying this.
No. It's. I think. I mean. I don't. I can't tell you.
His
I just
dad
know
was
I've
a Klansman. Fred Trump. That with his fucking when his Benny Hill looking ass was a Klansman, bro. Yeah.
Did you say Benny Hill?
Benny Hill.
Damn, it makes a noise. You know about Benny Hill.
Benny Hill is a man.
I knew he was gonna fucking.
Hold on.
I need that.
Only old motherfuckers know this. Benny Hill. Benny Hill was soft porn. Let's just be clear. That was soft porn.
Benny Hill would not get away with it today.
Oh, that nigga ain't no zip on this motherfucker. Goddamn.
So
yeah, fuck him. And everybody think like Trump is supposed to be some smart, super genius motherfucker. He's a clown.
Yeah.
Hey, man, that man about as smart as a soft dick. And just as useless.
I never heard that one.
Motherfucker dick, my soft dick ain't got no sense. He just flopping around, bro.
Bars.
And listen, bro. And to some people, man, he's the best fucking thing that's ever lived on this, ever walked the face of the earth. Yeah. With his...
But we can't say
wimpy
one
wimpy looking ass. Wimpy from Popeye looking ass.
Let me just be clear. I'm not a fan of Trump at all. But one thing I can say is, during the Trump era, there hasn't been a lot of broke people I've been running into. Like, everybody got money now.
Is I don't that, know. I you, think when Biden broke, took you office.
You got broke friends? I don't have no broke friends no more. I've been looking for them. They don't exist.
I don't know. Trump ain't did me no fucking favors.
No, he ain't do me no favor neither.
I'm just saying, like, you say he cut your taxes and shit. I mean, that's cool. And then, you know what? I have some conservative values, bro. I don't think it's my responsibility to take care of nobody else that I'm not right. down with taking care of. Mm. But I will put my money in infrastructure. Mm. You know, I do want my fuck. I do have, you know, if I do buy some tires, you know, some rims with some big tires on my shit or whatever, I do want my streets to be fixed so I don't have
your
to keep buying.
Your bricks
hold up. Yeah. I don't want my fucking structure to fall down and, you know what I mean?
Right.
Like, I'm down with the infrastructure. Part I'm down with seeing you know blacks and browns get money. I want to see them get some fucking money, bro. You know I want to take black people out of the minority because it's like one big fucking clusterfuck. So when it comes time to get contracts and shit, like, I get it. Mm-hmm. I get it. I got some values. I got some Republican values, bro. I don't think it's my responsibility to be paying for nobody else's insurance and shit. Like I got my own fucking problems. You feel me? Like, yo, that's where I'm at with it, bro. Like, I need to, I don't want to be paying for nobody else's shit. I want to take care of my own shit. So, less fucking government, in my opinion.
It's just Republican value, right?
Yeah, I got some conservative values.
Smaller
government. If somebody's fucked up, you know, don't penalize me because I'm
doing
all right.
There's too much bureaucracy anyways. And nothing going to get done anyways.
I love how politically y'all getting right now.
No, it's cool. You know, it's cool to have a Republican in the office, but not a Republican like this beanbag head motherfucker. He's a dummy.
He wasn't even really a Republican.
He's not really even a fucking president, but he's just standing there like he was some type of god, man. Just like he's a special one. He's not special. Mm-hmm. No, but values, man. Those conservative values, bro. Like, less government, man. Let's get it. You know, I don't need you to regulate my weed or regulate my alcohol or regulate some shit that I grow out of my fucking backyard. Don't tap into my shit. Tap into your own shit.
Right.
You know, a lot of black people put a lot of emphasis on Democrats. When the Democrats was the motherfuckers that wanted to keep us enslaved.
Original, yeah.
You know, and if it was that big a deal, then why aren't the Democrats fighting for the rights of these people that's not getting it?
You know, we not getting all that we supposed to have, and every time some shit come up, you know, that's supposed to favor us, you ain't saying shit. Mm. Why reparations ain't came up? You a fucking Democrat? You down? Then come on. Let's put the shit on the table, and let's start talking about it, and let's get some shit done. Mm. Let's talk, more action.
You voted for,
I did.
Biden?
I did.
Okay.
Because I wanted this fucking Alfred Hitchcock motherfucker out of the office, bro.
You voted against Trump.
I did. Right, I voted against him.
Right.
Yeah. But I also voted for Obama.
Let me ask you something. At one point, Trump was like rap's go-to guy.
He was cool as fuck.
He was cool.
And then he came out there and he started.
You ever had lyrics that you was bigging up Donald Trump?
I did. I said a nigga rolling hard, stacking paper like Trump.
Nobody thought he would be a president.
I don't give a fuck. I told you that from the jump. Yeah, that was the song I had called Money and the Power. But
you regret those lyrics or no?
Nah, man. Yeah, shit, that Trump was getting some money back then in the 90s.
I think I asked Raekwon the same thing, because I think he said, check who's the black Trump.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think he regretted it neither. I think he was like, yeah.
I ain't no black Trump, though. Yeah. I ain't, fuck him.
Yeah, but I mean, I don't think he was referencing to who Trump is now. I think he was referencing who Trump was back then.
Man,
because you
ain't
see
no black
Trump with Donald
Trump,
King.
White, man.
But you see, Trump was never a cool dude. Like, fuck
but
Trump.
But no, he kind of was a black man. Yeah, Snoop Dogg, he was hanging out with him. Donald Trump. I'm going to say Donald
like
Trump
said,
ain't
his
Donald
father,
Trump.
He comes
Don
from his father. He's his father's child.
Man, that shit, that boy True Colors came out, man.
Yeah, it came out, yeah. I agree.
Yeah, fuck Donald Trump, bro. Fuck him and fuck everything that's going to come behind him.
Didn't one of his people just get indicted?
Yeah. His,
and they took away Giuliani's...
Giuliani can't practice law no more.
What does that mean, though? Like, what does that exactly mean? Like,
what do you mean?
Can't practice
they
law.
They pulled... He's not a lawyer.
What did they catch him doing?
You can't go in the courtroom no more.
Yeah, but what did they catch him doing?
Nobody.
He was
down with that bullshit-ass... what did Donald Trump call it? A hoax.
Okay.
That the election was rigged and he shouldn't have did that.
Oh. And then what you were trying to talk about right now is one of his accountants for the Trump organization got indicted.
Yeah, his CFO or some shit, chief financial officer. Right. He banged up right now.
Damn, you really into this shit. You really know
your politics.
Yeah.
You really know your politics shit. That's
yeah, I'm
cool.
In the politics big time.
So
one of
the things that corrupt said is the Mr. Scarface. That song, how did you come up with that? How did you come up with
AC Binti Spider, man?
Damn, that shit, that's what that is? I was so familiar with it, but I never would have thought AC. Oh!
Come here, Scarface.
Fuck.
Oh, you fucking me up right now. Holy shit. No wonder the rhythm was so familiar.
It's a gun, man.
It was so familiar. But I holy shit. Damn, Scarface. Damn, you fucking me up. I did not know that. You remember we went out to eat and you got sick?
I did. That's why I didn't want to come on drink champ and drink. She got fucking get sick again. So I went out with N.O.R.E. It was where these yachts at. And I was eating some fucking crabs, bro.
Yeah.
And we was talking and all of a sudden my fucking throat swole up.
Yeah.
Oh, he told me. He said, I almost killed some face. I said, you killed a legend.
That motherfucker tried to kill me, bro.
Yo, we sit down.
I think that shit was stemming from a long time ago in Vegas, man.
So just so the people know.
He fucked me up.
Me and Face are sitting down. I'm filming my food show. And Face just start making these weird noises. He goes, just like, I don't know what.
The fuck out of here, N.O.R.E. The fuck out of here, bro.
What's the saying? Yeah, so he was there. I swear to God, out of the blue, Face just start making these weird noises. So I'm thinking my conversation is boring. So I'm like, oh, okay, let me set my game up. And then you did it again. You made a noise. He was like, man, something wrong with me. And I was like, really?
The fuck?
And then you got up, and then Randy Acker, you said something to Randy, and then the Everlast came, and my heart went to my ass. Because I said, if anything happened to Face while he's on my set, hip-hop's going to kill me.
Oh,
I'm like, I'm hitting Randy every 5 minutes. Is Face all right? Is he all right? Is he all right? Because I never dealt with food poisoning. And that's what I first thought they thought it was, food poisoning. Or what eventually did happen?
Should I had an allergic reaction?
Allergic reaction. That's food poisoning.
Crab and shit?
Yeah.
I was in that mug.
Yeah. I'm telling you, it was a weird noise. Was
making. Fucking lockjaw. I was fucked up.
Wow. Wow.
Yeah,
that's the first time you found out you're allergic to whatever the fuck you was eating?
I was just allergic that day because when I ate it again, I was fine.
Right.
Yeah, that's your fault.
I don't think it might have been you, bro.
Oh, shit. Blame it on N.O.R.E. With all fans. Whoa, man. I don't mind.
Yeah, man. N.O.R.E. always doing some shit.
I don't mind. But I heard you say something earlier. You said Vegas. I think that's the first time I met you. It was you, E-40, Mac-10.
Yeah.
Mac-10.
You, E-40, Mac-10. I want to say Dub C, but I'm not confidently sure. And that's the first time I drank with E-40, and we drank something called Moesha's. And I drank about 10 of them, and then I asked E-40, what the fuck is a Moesha? And he said, straight brandy, pimp. And I was fucked up in the MGM Grand. And here's what's crazy. It wasn't Vegas. It was Reno. Remember when they had the Impact Conventions?
That's how much it fucked you up. You fucked up the whole city?
No. It was Reno. Cause
I don't remember.
Yeah. I remember that shit.
I think I did so much traveling and so much.
Right.
So much dope.
Right.
I don't remember nothing, bro. I'm fucked up.
And when you say dope, what do you mean?
Shit, you name it.
Okay.
I did all the kind of shit that'll get you high.
Wow.
Except crack.
Wow.
And heroin. Pills and a lot of dope. Smoke a lot of weed. Smoked a lot of amp.
What's amp?
Bombing fluid.
Oh, wait.
Dust. PCP, you got butt naked.
Angel dust?
I've been high. I ain't never been butt naked though. Okay. I ain't want nobody looking at my dick. No, I got high, man. Shit.
You liked it, the dust high? That's something.
Really? That's why I quit.
That's why you quit, because you liked
too
it?
Good?
Loved it.
All right, so now, people, you seen yellow leprechauns?
I ain't seen none of that shit.
Yeah, because that's they hallucinate on dust, right? Because I took a mess tab and I got on a seesaw by myself.
A mess tab?
Yeah, mess tab. It's called mescaline. And I got on a seesaw by myself. You know, a seesaw, you need two people. She was going up and down.
How'd that work out?
I don't know. It worked out, though. I don't know who's on the side, maybe.
Nah, that shit just make you move.
You tapped into a certain dimension.
See, nowadays, the kids, they ain't getting the right shit.
Right. They're getting what is it called?
Fentanyl? I don't know what it's called.
Fentanyl?
Yeah.
That shit is fucking
that shit killing me.
Fingernail polish or some shit.
Right.
Man, when we got our squares from Rosalie, our shit was green.
Dipped in that embalming fluid.
It wasn't brown. It wasn't red.
Embalming fluid?
Yeah, embalming fluid.
Damn.
Boy, you hit that shit 3 or 4 times and you be chilling like this and all of a sudden be like.
You felt embalmed.
Wait, you felt like a spider?
You feel slow. You feel like
moving like a spider.
She be moving like this, and all of a sudden they hit the remote. You be Steve Austin, remember the $6 million man? Yeah. Like when a motherfucker making that move and they making it slow motion. Yeah, you fucked up.
How about coke? You ever did coke?
Yeah, I might have seen it.
Yeah, because in the 80s, y'all was a little
loose. You seen it?
Oh yeah.
Okay, he did.
It was like it was like we would rock up the dope and the shake that was left over.
Mm. Oh shit.
We would put it in a mold.
You put it in a what?
In a weed square.
You smoking dirties.
That's what it's called?
Danks, dirties?
I said we was rocking up 8 balls and mowing a scrape. Mm. 20,000 in my pocket, no, 7,000 in my pocket, 7 more in the safe. You hear me, N.O.R.E.?
I hear you. Hold on, I got somebody else want to FaceTime in.
I was rocking up 8 balls and mowing a scrape. That's what y'all primos.
Dirties.
Yeah.
I hear they call them dirties.
And danks.
Yeah.
7,000 in my pocket, 20 more in the safe. There he is.
T.I.P. Make some noise for T.I.P.
What's up, family? I got a good one for you, man. Check this out.
Press the phone.
Come up, boy. Hey, this gonna give me my kidney though.
Oh man. Oh man.
Word.
Yes, sir.
What's going on, King?
Man, can't call.
That's my son, man.
He gonna give him a kidney, goddammit.
Yes, sir.
That's the real MVP.
What's happening, family?
Man, you're a real one, bro. I was supposed to be there, man, but I ran over time on the boat. I'm sorry.
Oh, yeah, he's supposed to be our guest host. Surprise you, yeah. We went all out for you. We went all out for you.
I forgot it was 4th of July. My old lady got me on the boat.
Man, that's all right, man. Enjoy your family, man. You good?
Man, shit, good as a kid, baby.
I already know, bro. I already know, man.
Hey, man, listen, bro. You know me and you had this conversation all the time, man.
Yeah.
I always want to take the opportunity to salute you, show you the love and respect you deserve, and the admiration that, you know, you earn coming from where we come from. You did. I know. We know how tough it was for us, so I can imagine how tough it was for y'all. You know what I mean?
Did.
Being out there, you know, the only motherfucker from down bottom, represent.
Man, we did what we had to do, Tip. You know.
We can't thank you enough.
Nah, we can't thank you enough either, homie. We appreciate you, King.
Thank you, Tip.
You feel me?
Love and respect, man.
Ain't nothing but love and respect, man.
Yeah. 1,000.
My nigga, man. For real. Solid dude. Always been solid.
Yo, T.I., thank you so much, King.
Man, love. Y'all take it easy.
I'm going to hit you up when I finish here. I hit you up, my bro. All right. Thank you. All right. God damn, make some noise for T.I.P., god damn. Hey, everybody, take their time out their day. Stop to make sure.
Nah, T.I. the real deal, man.
They show you love, bro.
I know when when I was talking about my kidney, bro, like he was fucking trying to get me one that night.
Get out of here.
Man, T.I. was the man. He was trying to get that kidney right then. He was wow. Like, fuck it, man. Anybody got a kidney for face, man, we're going to give him a bag.
Wow.
Yeah. Mm.
So let me ask you, as at one point, everyone credits you as the king of the South. Yeah. Everyone credits you as the king of the South, right? Everyone credits you as the king of the South.
That's in one's opinion, and, you know.
And then at one point, T.I. actually started this whole campaign of him saying he was the king of the South. Was there any, like, discrepancies? Any, like, thoughts of that?
It wasn't a battle. Everybody should feel like they're the king of something, you know?
Right.
And I always said that, you know, Tip can have that title. It's too much responsibility any motherfucking way.
Mm-hmm.
But now that we're older and we're more wiser, we can both share that fucking title.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Because we kings like a motherfucker.
Right. You definitely the king of the South.
No.
To the majority. Absolutely. Of people.
I mean, we
but
both are.
But it doesn't take away from T.I. I don't think it takes away anything from
T.I. is a genius also, man. He moved into, you know, legend status, man. He didn't let what happened to him in his dealing with these funky ass feds, get him off his game. Mm-hmm. You know, he did his time, got right back on his motherfucking game, and did his thing. So, right. You know, big shouts out to him.
So, was it anybody at that time trying to put y'all against odds or something like that?
It's gonna be impossible to put me at odds with a motherfucker unless we really at odds in the first place, because there ain't gonna be no rap no more.
Right.
You know. So we ain't never pushed the envelope, man. We always been tight. You know, like I said, I was trying to get T.I. on Def Jam back. And I was trying to get him back on Def Jam back in the gap.
Right.
But everybody was like, yeah, man, he was already on Polygram. I was like, what the fuck difference does that make?
Right.
It's a bad little nigga, man. Y'all better come on.
Right.
And nobody want to get in that boat. You know, Def Jam, remember that boat I was telling you about?
Yep.
They want that boat.
Wow.
So And then T.I. goes to Atlantic. Blows the fuck up. But look at me. Who am I? You know?
What's your favorite part of the game? Is it making the music or performing it? Take a shot for that? Let's take a shot for that. Well, if you say both.
I can't say both no more. I want to save y'all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Our livers, thank you.
I love making beats, man. Mm. No. I got a whole studio in my house that I don't even walk in no more. I haven't walked in that motherfucker in a year.
Wow. Was it just for making beats?
It's just for, you know, it's production, period.
Didn't Capone come and stay with you for like a month or something like
that?
Didn't Capone tell us a crazy ass story?
I forget.
Well, he told me a crazy ass story.
What do you say, man?
It's not.
I can tell you if it's a lie.
Nah, I'm not gonna tell
you. I'd rather say it because if it's a lie.
He just said you a real motherfucker. He just to say it that way. I'll tell you off the podcast.
I mean, that's
you remember the story he told at the airport?
Yeah.
Nah, Capone came to my house.
Yeah. I'm listening. I'm trying to get on the phone.
And Rumble,
let Capone say it on the podcast.
Okay, let's see. He probably on the grill. But good. Yeah, I forgot it's 4th of July. I seriously don't really celebrate holidays no more.
My daughter did not forget.
I celebrate Juneteenth.
Yeah, I celebrate Juneteenth too.
Yeah, fuck the 4th. Right. That's when America gained its independence. We ain't get our independence.
Yeah, we were still slaves, right?
Back in 1776 or whenever the fuck they called. Yeah, fuck that shit, man. Like, I'm the most unpatriotic. Let me tell you why I'm so fucking unpatriotic, bro. It's because you don't see black people, bro.
Right.
You don't see us, man, and we was here.
Right.
Motherfuckers fought in your army and fought in your wars and stood for your flag and pledged allegiance to the motherfucker, and you still don't recognize us as being human beings, so fuck you. We don't recognize you now. Right. Juneteenth, bitch.
Right. Goddamn.
That's when we gained our independence.
Right.
Juneteenth.
Right.
So.
And when is Juneteenth? It's June 19th, correct?
Right.
All right, because it always just feel like June 18th. I don't know why.
Yeah, we got released from slavery a little late in Texas.
Wow.
You know, but.
And wasn't Arizona the same thing, I believe?
Because Texas thought it was his own country.
I don't think Arizona
released now.
Martin Luther King birthday as a holiday.
That was John McCain.
Yeah. That was John McCain
that didn't want that leprechaun. Shit. Yeah, that guy.
That was him. Really?
Fonzie.
The little leprechaun, yeah.
Fonzie.
Yeah. He looked like Danny DeVito in the Yala. Yeah.
Uh-huh. But if you can make John McCain and George Bush Sr. look human.
Right. That's what Trump did.
Then you got to be a piece. You got to be a big piece of shit.
And George Bush is not in there as well? Because you're George Bush from your town.
Yeah,
right?
No, George Bush. I mean, George Bush Sr., George Bush Jr. I ain't got no problem with him. But I'm just saying, right, if you can make George Bush Sr. and Jr.
look
human,
which is what Trump
along
did
with John McCain,
yeah,
you got to be a really big piece of shit.
Right.
And when I saw Trump at Bush's funeral, I looked at the president's
Senior
previous.
Bush?
Yeah, Senior Bush's funeral.
Senior Bush died?
Been gone.
Yeah, bro, come on,
man. Where the fuck have I been at? Really?
And Trump disrespected the shit out of McCain.
Told him he said he's not even a war hero. Right?
Yeah, Trump, yeah, he never like, fucking fought no war.
Like
never.
We like people that haven't been captured.
Yeah.
Disrespect the shit out of him, man.
But listen, Trump did turn politics to a smack DVD. Let's just be clear.
And that's not good.
I'm not saying it's good, but I'm just
not
saying.
Not good, man.
I never watched the debate like I watched this. I had popcorn this time. Like,
I mean, I guess if you want to get people engaged.
I never looked like debate like entertainment. Like, I looked at debate like it was a smack DVD.
Hey, man, this
like Drake was battling Murder Mook. That's how I looked at it. I was like, Drake and Murder Mook about to go at it.
He ran his country like a fucking...
It was Versus.
A reality show host.
Absolutely like a reality show.
That motherfucker, when they was walking...
Said, you fired.
What was that? The parliament? What's that thing that they have that all the presidents go to? Fuck.
Oh, well, he ain't go to. It's like the brunch.
He went. It's in Germany.
Okay.
Oh, the G some shit, you know, right?
G7? G4, G7, whatever the fuck it is. Everybody's walking in front of Trump. Trump's like...
Yeah.
Got in front of everybody. Like, he's the big bad motherfucker. Huh. Like, I like to box that big bitch.
Who, Trump?
I like to box that old bitch. Just to show him that he's not as tough. And then I want to play him in some golf. And then I want to show him my dick is way bigger than his. Because he think he all that. Fuck that guy.
That went all the way left.
I'm just saying, he act like he's just an amazing motherfucker, man. Let's have a pissing contest.
We got to do a little shot today. Let's just do a tiny shot, please.
A tiny shot?
A tiny shot.
No, I can't be bigger than that, dude. Let's have a pissing contest, you motherfucker.
So will you go back into on politics? You going back into it?
I'm definitely going back.
Okay.
And I want to be remembered as a motherfucker who got on Drink Champs and told the world to fuck themselves.
That's fine. You want to take a shot?
I don't.
Okay. All right, I'm going to take a shot.
No, I'm good. Yeah.
This is that Japanese whiskey.
Thanks, pal.
21 year.
Cheers to the legend, baby.
Enjoy yourself.
Habiki. That's how you say it? Habiki.
Well, that's a Japanese.
I don't think that. I think that people around the world see the condition of all black people.
Right.
And they're not saying or doing the motherfucking thing. They're not making it illegal.
Did you notice? I'm sorry to cut you off to a certain extent, but did you notice that the most racist place you've ever been is America? Like, I've gone to place like a Germany where it's supposed to be racist and they show black people more love. There, Japan. I remember going to Japan with 8-Ball and MJG, and I remember just these people just showed us tremendously. That was the first time I felt like a god. Like when they say black people are gods, that's the first time I felt like god because I was in Japan. What kind of things do you go through when you go overseas and you come back here, and how does it make you feel?
I'm scared as fuck to go overseas.
Wait a minute, you never been overseas? This is amazing.
Like, I'm scared, bro. Like,
I've never been to Europe.
I know.
You've never been to Germany.
Because I don't want nobody fucking with me because I'm black, bro.
No, it's not like that over there.
Man, don't fuck with me, bro.
It's actually the total opposite. Yeah.
Because what I'm going to do, they're going to fuck with me, man.
But not Russia.
I'm going
to
go ape shit.
Okay, Russia, don't go to Russia.
Shout out to Russia. We got to give it a second chance.
Listen, man.
Not the time we ain't ever been with Russia.
Somebody's going to get way out of line. I'm going to go ape shit, and I'm going to be in that jail,
bro. I'm going to be honest with you, Face. Let me tell you. I'm going to give you a story of me being in Berlin, Germany one year. The promoters.
That's where the swastika comes from.
Yeah, look, so I went there one year. The promoter comes, he pays me, does everything, but then the promoter disappears. So I'm sitting around like, you know, we're not lost or something, but I just can't find the promoter. You know what the promoter did? He went and wrote graffiti, Capone and N.O.R.E. He did a whole piece so when we walk in. He wanted us to see that Germany still keeps graffiti alive. And it was the most, like, respect. But I took it as disrespect because he just disappeared. But he was trying to make us... What I'm trying to say is sometimes in overseas, in parts of London, in parts of Germany, in parts of Amsterdam, they live out more hip-hop than we do. They still break dancing. They're still doing graffiti. They're still doing all of these elements of hip-hop that we lost. We just feel like we could rap and that's it. And... Hip hop. When Nas said hip hop was dead, I believed him because hip hop was in overseas. It really was. I kid you not. I never felt more hip hop because you got to realize I wasn't out in the '80s. I saw the '80s, right. But I wasn't out. I didn't have music out. I didn't have music out in the early '90s. I had music out in the late '90s. But it was a whole bunch of era that I didn't miss from not participating. But when I go to these certain places.
Haven't performed overseas at all?
Ever.
Not even South America?
Not even trying.
Africa never? This is amazing.
So you've obviously turned down offers.
Yeah.
You gotta go, man.
Word. And you're not gonna...
That will change your...
Motherfuckers will put me in jail over
there,
man.
Nah. It'll change your perspective.
I won't be able to talk to nobody, be hot in that motherfucker, nah. Ain't got no food.
Some places, yes, but not most places.
They're gonna go ASAP Rocky you.
I don't mesh well with others, man. Like, if some shit jump off, like, I'm going ape shit.
Nah, like, you need to... I think it would change your perspective.
It ain't gonna work.
You know this crazy shit? I'm 5%, you know, so I... You know, I've watched all. And Germany was the exact opposite of what I thought it would be. Like, I thought I was going to land and there's going to be like people like this. Hell, Hitler. Like, I really did think that. And yeah. And when I landed, and it was the exact, I guess they worked on their racism more than a lot of other.
They were so critical after the Nazis that they.
Yeah, like, it was literally like. Left. It was literally like, hey, what's up, black man? Like, everywhere I was at, like, it was just like and you got to realize, they never seen us. Like, they never seen our people. So it's amazing because, one, they never seen our people. And two, when they find out who you are. And three, they'll never get to see hip-hop like us. Like, we get to see Young Thug and, you know, Hitmaker every fucking week or every out here in Miami. Fabulous comes every week, every month. So we get spoiled. They're not going to ever be spoiled because Scarface is never going to come there every Saturday. Beatnuts are never going to come there every Saturday. So the fact when Scarface do show up there, they're going to show the fuck out. I do not work for these promoters, I highly recommend you go.
I think we just discovered the biggest travel show ever. Executive produced by Drink Chance.
Yes. Where you bring Scarface to Europe. World. Yeah, bring Scarface overseas. I love that show idea.
Yeah. I'm telling you, I think that you would. No, I'm not going to do it. Don't worry. Hold up.
Do you fish? You fish?
I do.
Okay. Yeah, let's do some fishing in Europe. What the fuck? Hell yeah.
Can I take my boat?
No.
Okay, Scarface, you go get boats over there. You can't bring your boat from Houston. How the fuck you
ride that motherfucker?
What are we gonna do with that?
You like KRS One? You want to take a boat across?
Yeah, KRS.
You don't fly?
Yeah.
No, I fly.
Okay,
I flew here.
Yeah, KRS One don't fly.
So your whole career, let me just ask. This is so interesting to me. Sorry, fans. Sorry if you're not interested in this part, but there's people been asking you for these shows, and what do you say? You just say no.
It's not enough money, man.
Wow.
No, if I go over there, I want to have a tour. I want to hop from country to country to country to country to state to state. To
so city. Willie D and Bushwick never.
They went to you know what? They and my DJ too.
Oh, they left you.
Motherfucker left me and went to Korea. No, where y'all went, Don? Don.
Yo.
Where y'all went?
No, to Korea.
He left you now.
He said. He said, "What country boys y'all left?" Y'all.
Yeah,
and he went. He left him and went to.
Him, he ain't want
to
fly.
Right, to Korea.
He scared to fly. No, he went to Japan.
Okay, to Japan. Okay, all right. See, this is different. You said you want to go.
Yeah, you didn't want to fly. Or you don't want
to
go there.
To fly? Is that it?
I didn't want to go.
You just ain't want to go. Damn, man. They would have loved you a long time out there. Man.
I'm good. I got love me a long time. I got love me a long time at home.
Godmother Chico.
I got love me a long time at home. I'm good. I'm
you don't
great.
Got more blunts?
Want a beer?
No.
Holy shit.
Hey, you know what? I sent that to you, yeah?
Yeah, you sent me that. So, all right. Damn, bro! I'm discovering shit I never knew.
There you go.
Oh, okay. I'm discovering shit I never knew. I did not know.
It gets better.
Now I got like two more questions, and then we can wrap it up. Holy shit! Okay. All right. In Between Us, featuring Nas.
Yeah.
How did that happen?
I can't remember.
Man, we have a problem here, man.
How it came out, goddamn.
Good.
I don't remember, but this was a song.
See, I don't feel too bad about my record anymore.
So I was making beats.
Mm-hmm. You made a beat for Nas?
Yeah, I did.
And then you called him?
No. What
the fuck, man?
You gonna play us a beat?
I'm gonna play a song that you never heard before.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, wow. We into that.
Hey, how you doing?
That's my shit.
You want the speaker?
Just want to let you know that I'm your little girl.
You can.
She's dying to meet you.
I hear it. Good.
Yeah, I'm gonna call you back.
These are the beats I was making back then.
Tell me you're gonna call me back and you do. I'm gonna call you back. I remember when we first met, the shit was a go. She was a friend of a friend's friend. I met at the show. Bright skin, cold black.
So these are the beats like I was making, and then it kind of came to. I did the In Between Us.
along with Mike. My Uncle Eddie played the bass on it.
Mike who?
Mike Dean. Okay. Dinger. Dinger played some keys on it. Uncle Eddie played some bass on it. And Nas was in Atlanta, man. And Nas, the first verse he took was some of the stuff he laid down on Ether. Mm. Some of those lyrics. I hope your wife cook your blood with a cook your food with a period blood or something, you know. Yeah.
Wait, what?
Mm-hmm. I hope your wife cook your food with a period blood. Nas said that.
That's terrible.
Yeah.
He said it on Ether?
He said that in between us, yeah. And I was like, nah, we ain't gonna, you know, Nas, we can't go at cuz like that, you know, not on here. Like Nas.
Wait, was, is this the first time that no one's never heard this before?
Nas went at Jay on.
Oh, he said this to Jay?
He went at Jay on that record.
That record you just played?
No. Oh. On
In Between Us.
Okay.
You all right?
He's about to die. Don't worry about him.
Yeah, he dies every week.
Paramedics. We have paramedics.
And our engineer does cocaine. It's all right. Don't worry about it.
And I was like, bro, let's do something.
So he started his verse off, I hope your wife.
No, he was like, I can't remember.
Go ahead, Face. Don't worry about it.
At this point of the show, everybody starts dying. So
yeah. Okay. I can't remember everything that was said, but he fucking went off.
Wow.
And I was like, man, we not gonna do it like that, Nas. We're just gonna make some records, man. You know.
And he went and changed it?
He went back and did a whole nother verse, and it was, you know. It was clean. It was just as dope.
You ever felt caught in their drama?
Say it again.
You ever felt like you was caught in their drama?
I don't do that.
Right.
You know, I watch the fuckers, the bombs fly overhead, but I don't never reach in and grab one. That ain't where I'm at. Right. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not in there.
Right.
Like, don't fucking put me in that shit. If y'all squabbling, my nigga, then let me stay where I'm at. I got my own lane.
An MC tried to diss another MC on your record?
I don't know.
Okay. That's but okay.
It could have happened and you didn't catch it.
I never tried to do a whole lot of records with a lot of people though, you know?
Right.
It'd be hard as fuck to perform the records.
Right.
Yeah.
You remember performing at
Nope.
The Gathering of the Juggalos?
Yeah.
So, because Nori don't know, I've been to the Gathering of the Juggalos twice. Sorry.
Yeah, listen, they ain't invite me. I want to go.
You want to go? No, I'm not having it right now.
You don't want to go, man.
So, what did you think about that experience?
If they don't like you, then they ain't going to throw nothing at you.
No, if they like you, they fuck you up.
If they like you, though, man, you got fucking 40-ounce bottles and.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Fucking mannequins.
What's you with 40 ounces?
Man, mannequins and all kinds of shit they throw up on the stage. They don't give a fuck.
I don't even know how that fits. Man. A mannequin?
And I told you.
The dude that's crazy, right?
But it's something different.
Right? Motherfucker, throw something. You want to go out there and beat some ass, right?
Yeah, but it's too many people.
No, it's too many people.
It's crazy, right?
It's got to be 50,000 people. All going ape shit. They throwing
in the middle of nowhere.
They throwing firecrackers and shit up there at you.
At the stage?
Hey, man, dude. Like, you want to laugh hard as fuck? Yeah. I swear to God.
It's like the purge.
Hey, Dom. Man, come show Nori where the man bent his old lady over and put his dick in her while we was on stage at the Gathering. What? What'd you say? Cuz fucked his old lady on stage at the Gathering.
I don't think we want to see this.
I'm in.
Yeah.
All right. Yo, that shit is something different.
Yeah, man.
He fucked on stage?
On stage.
And I believe
you. People walk around butt naked.
Because you know, down south, y'all have a certain type of slang where y'all say old lady, but you mean your girl.
It's bro.
This is his girl.
Yeah. Right.
It wasn't an old lady.
Yeah, but they say down south, though, just to be.
I'm just asking, just though. It's the way you describe it.
Yeah,
it wasn't an old lady. It wasn't like a 90-year-old chick.
Nah.
Like, it wasn't
I mean,
like
she
that.
Looked 90, but no.
This is his girl. He fucked his girl on stage.
I mean, you can't see shit, but you know they fucking.
Yo, this shit is crazy, man.
Yeah,
I'm not everybody jumping wanna, around having a good time. You want to go do some shit?
If they throw a bottle of 40 ounce at me, I'm gonna be honest.
If they like you, what's the soda pop they drink? What's it called? Face?
Fuego.
Fuego. Yo, they throw that shit right the fuck at you like rockets. That shit is crazy.
Hey. Insane clown posse pull up these fucking rigs, man, full of that fucking soda water.
Yep.
And they grab the hose and they just shoot that shit out in the crowd.
They got like four stages, they got mud wrestling.
The shit is crazy as fuck.
This is the purge.
It's the purge.
It's the purge.
Yeah. It's crazy, bro. Bro, it's crazy.
But it's something to experience, though.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
It's insane.
It's the same clown posse.
Yeah.
And worse than that.
All right, but let's take it to the La Familia album. This Can't Be Life. What happens? Jay no calls fuck. You. And what happens?
So Jay calling me to come to the studio.
You need another McCallum?
Nope.
Okay.
Jay called me to come to the studio. And I get a phone call. I think my brother might have called me, man. Yeah. And told me that, Rico had lost his son, man. And Brad was like 2 years old, and all I could think about was thinking, you know, it was my kid, you know. And Brad 23 now. But all I could think about was Junior, man, and fuck. You know, so I was fucked up, man. I got from what I hear from him was that his son got a hold to somebody's heroin.
Damn.
Now, don't quote me on that, but that's what I heard. And that shit was so devastating to me because, for one, me being the father of some children, of some boys, I don't even know how to digest losing my boy, you know, to some shit that, like, it's fucking devastating, man. So I go upstairs and the beat is playing.
Who did this beat?
I don't know, man.
Damn.
Hold on. Had to be Kanye, man. Because I'm thinking about all of the elements of the music, and you kind of know different producers from different producers. Mm-hmm. And then, It had to be Kanye. I sat there and I listened to it, man. And like I said at the end, man, I could have rapped about my hard times in this song.
What you rapping about the homie?
Heaven knows I would have been wrong. It wouldn't have been right. Mm. It wouldn't have been life. It wouldn't have been love. It wouldn't have been us. It can't be life. So, yeah. Yeah, it was devastating, bro.
Wow.
Yeah. I have fun, bro. Really? You know, I'm not making no more albums, right?
Nah, come on.
Kanye? He said it. It was Kanye.
Yeah, you can listen to it. I can listen to it. I can tell you who did it. If I fuck with the producer, I know exactly who did what.
Right.
You know, I can listen to it.
You're not making no more albums?
I'm done.
Yeah, nah, yeah. That's terrible.
It's time to move on.
Are you doing features?
I'm 50. I'm doing 50.
So you're not doing no features?
I'm doing 50. I'm
50 chilling. Features?
No, I'm chilling.
Oh, you man, about listen, to be 50,
listen,
you
I'm 50 now.
Yeah,
I just turned 50.
Let's not listen
man,
to that
listen
part.
To me, man. I'm going to play golf. I'm going to get out on my yacht. I'm going to fish. You know.
I'm you say get out on your yacht? On that's my what makes me yacht. Yacht, goddammit.
It ain't no big ass yacht.
It doesn't matter. It's a yacht.
It was a gift.
Yes, that's fine.
You got a gift? A yacht is a gift?
That's fucking right.
God,
you kidding me?
Yeah.
What friends you got?
Nah, I called Jay. I was like, you know,
Jay?
Yeah, I was like, man, listen.
What's Jay? James. Jay Prince.
James,
or
yeah, James. Okay. I said, yeah, man, so you still got that 37 footies? Oh, yeah. I said, shit. You want to sell it? He said, yeah, I get off of it. I said, well, how much you want for it? He said, depending on who want it. I said, shit, I want it. He said, you know what, man? You can have that motherfucker. So.
And you drive it yourself?
Always. Yeah. I ain't never drove that yacht because I ain't been home to fuck with it. But yeah, I had one already.
But you had a yacht
already. Someone else 24 gave years you old. Yacht? That boat on the cover of the Source. That was my real fucking boat. That wasn't no play motherfucking boat that a nigga got on for props. That was my shit. Yeah, and talk that shit. When we talk that shit,
the stunt is serious. The stunt is serious.
You want to talk that shit? Y'all 23, 24 with a yacht. So yeah.
No, no, rented yacht.
No, my shit wasn't rented.
No, the other motherfucker.
No, my shit, you're lying.
Let me ask you. At one point, Pimp C said that the South don't even start until it gets to Houston. Because
I don't know nothing about.
Everywhere else had a different time zone.
That was how it felt.
Okay.
I don't know.
Oh, because, the time zones.
Yeah, so he's trying to say even Miami.
Yeah, even Miami's not.
Yeah,
that really doesn't make sense.
And if you listen to what he's saying, on the East Coast Conference in basketball, Miami is the East Coast.
Miami is the East Coast.
What about Mississippi and Alabama?
I don't know. I was just asking.
Georgia, come on.
I was wondering, did anybody
Georgia's
else?
On East Coast time. But them my down south niggas, though. All
right.
That's down south.
All right. I was wondering, did anybody else
and from Miami's the boss,
Texas man. Feel like that?
Feel like I don't even think we think like that. We ain't tripping on that.
Yeah.
Anybody on that bottom down there with us, we fucking with y'all. We down with you.
Right.
It don't stop.
Right. God damn it, man. Make some noise for Scarface, man. I got like one more question, and that's it. You got something to eat? Oh, shit, man. You answered everything, man. Hold on. Let me see. Okay, Homes and Thugs.
Homes and Thugs?
Yeah.
What about them?
How'd you come up with that?
You know what? I didn't come up with that.
Really?
Jay came up with that.
Wow.
I was making a...
Now, when you say Jay, you got to remember...
Jay Prince. Yeah.
Yeah, it's two.
No, it's a difference.
Okay.
A Jig and Jay with me.
Okay.
All right.
All
right. So... I was doing a compilation album with all the MCs and shit around the city that I really liked and from, you know, that hopped on the tour bus or, you know, from whatever state or town we was in. You know, I just bring niggas home. Like, if you was dope, nigga, get on the bus.
Right.
That motherfucker ain't stopped smoking. We been here 2 or 3 hours. It ain't even.
Yeah.
Chief.
Yeah. He's been with him since 11 years old.
He say what?
He's been with him since he's 11 years old. He's also a child crap trafficker as well.
Who, me? Fuck you, bitch.
Hey, man, you better let him go, bro.
He's from Peru. He just kidnapped him from Peru. And he made him wrestle. I don't know why he made him wrestle. Wrestle other people. Because wrestling is awesome. Power drive.
Those are weird rumors.
Yeah, he made him wrestle.
He brought one child trafficker or no, sex traffickers.
No, that was a whole preneur. She was a whole preneur. She was trying to get her holism together, you said, right?
No, she was rehabilitating.
Rehabilitated holism.
But she was a trafficker.
No.
At one point she
was actually
got trafficked.
She was trafficked.
Oh wow. Wow, that's real.
She was trafficked.
Yo, you gotta hear it on our podcast, man. Ghetto Boys Reloaded.
There we go.
Ghetto Boys
Join our
Make
shit.
Some Ghetto Boys Reloaded.
There we go. Look, we run out.
So hold on. We're gonna finish what was the last thing Homes, was it called?
Homies and Thugs.
Yeah, Homies and Thugs.
That was Jay's idea, man. Like, I was doing a compilation album, and Master P was bubbling like a motherfucker. So Jay wanted to put Master P on that fucking album. Mm. And I was like, fuck. Like, I fought him tooth and nail, man.
Why, you didn't want
because,
Master P?
No, because Master P wasn't on my label, bro. Master P was on his own shit. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Like, so I didn't really want P on that record. You know what I'm saying? I didn't. And what? P was my nigga, too, but it was showcasing.
Do you think you was wrong now?
Or huh?
You think you was wrong now?
No, I'm gonna stand on my motherfucking feet. You still stand on my feet,
oh,
yeah.
Wow. Oh, wow.
I don't give a fuck about none of that. No. I mean, I was trying to break my artist. Oh. And P came in there and stole the shine. He was like, ah! And I was like, fuck!
Ice Cream Man.
Ice Cream Man got on my shit. And stole my heart and shine, man. But that's all right. Much love to P.
Much love to P. Now, keep me down. This is the last question.
It's a cold motherfucker there. Mm-hmm. Kane rapped it. We made something out of nothing and vowed to never tear it apart. We turned the street hustle into an art that would quickly change life forever for us. Mm. No more riding bikes and catching the bus. We on the roll up.
Wow.
With money to fold up. Cognac, cooked Yola. Wow. Got the neighborhood about to blow up. Mm. Hold up. I see this van sitting. This old man in the fitted. Trying to get your little homie toe up. Yo, bruh. We ain't working in this neighborhood. Take your ass on, hog. Before you make me feed your ass to my dog, you fucking faggot. I know you want to catch me with this bag so you can hide me. Or with my 44 so you can 45 me. Like, that was just one of them records, man, that talking about motherfuckers trying to keep you down, man. I know you want to catch me with this bag so you can hide me and put me in jail forever. Mm. Or with my 44 so you can 45 me. Mm. You know, I pull out my 44, you pull out your 45. It's just wordplay.
Wordplay at its motherfucking finest, man. Scarface, we just want you to know our show is about giving people their flowers. It's about. good
move. It's done.
No more air there, I don't think.
That's how much we respect you.
Yes.
That was a brand new one.
Our show is about giving people flowers, so.
Never really looked at it like that, though. Never really looked at my career or my life like that. Like, I was like, I'm so fucking great, bro. When I'm just, I'm just mediocre, man, trying to live.
You need to stop that.
You're not mediocre. I can't let you get away with that at all.
Tell a lie, man. I'm just glad to still be alive. I'm glad to be able to take, you know, music and experiences, man. And put the motherfuckers on paper and put them on tape and let motherfuckers hear, you know, what I went through or what I witnessed. And it's not really all that big a deal to me.
Big deal to everybody.
That's a big deal to everyone else. And we just want to give you your roses, give you your flowers, let you know how, you know,
great you are. And real quick, and face, like, because I'm from Miami, and this is the part of the show that I rep. And when we was down south, we had the Gucci Crews, the Poison Clans, the Two Live Crews, all these guys. And then they all a part of our DNA down south.
I love Poison Clan.
But when it came to what we were seeking lyrically, Geto Boy, Scarface, that's what we were looking at.
Right.
And then you had Outkast. And then you had Dungeon
Fever. I love Outkast.
And that's the lineage of what we were looking at and what we were inspired by. So please understand that.
So I started fucking her, and after a while, she said it was a birthday, and she cracked a smile. I said, bitch, what the fuck are you telling me for? I don't give a damn about your birthday, whore. Poison Clan is one of my favorite groups, man.
JT Money, Poison Clan? Yeah. Come on, man.
Yeah, that's my favorite. Okay.
Would you do verses?
Nah, I'm not interested.
Really?
Come on, man.
You know what?
Against T.I., the King of the South?
Nah, that ain't gonna be a good one.
Okay.
I wanna do one with Ice Cube.
That'd be a good one. That'd be a great one.
It's not like a versus, like, you know, comparing catalogs. It's like
celebration.
That's what it is, celebrating each other.
Nah, it's gonna be bigger than that.
I would say
it's not a versus. It's a
So what about all three? Public Enemy, Ice Cube, and you.
It's like I love and respect Ice Cube so motherfucking much until I would love to sit in front of him and play my shit and say, hey, man, do you remember when you said so and so? Because I know all his shit, too. All
right.
So all right. That would be a versus that I would love to do.
I see it.
And it wouldn't be like me versus him. It would be like us.
I think that's what this all is now. It's a celebration. It all started out with versus.
No, because I seen some of Keith Sweat's and Bobby Brown shit, and it looked like them niggas was kind of at odds a little bit.
Nah, I got
it. It looked like Bobby was trying to dance against Keith, and Keith was trying to sing against Bobby.
The only part that I seen that was a little crazy was when Keith said, I got this Ciroc, and then Bobby said, drink responsibly. Drink responsibly,
yeah. Them fucking fighting words, man.
Yeah, that was a little bit fighting words. I'm
gonna get drunk, goddamn it. Yeah, don't help me out.
He talked about drink responsibly. Like, you don't trust me. That was the only part that was a little sketchy to me. I was like, wait a minute. Why did he just tell a man to drink responsibly? You know that's like put your napkin on your lap. Or stick your napkin in your shit. Like, it's like that. But yo, Face Small, man, let me just tell you something, man. We waited 5 years for this, man. This was worth every moment. We really love you. We really went all out and hit everybody.
Y'all almost fucked me up in here.
Yeah.
Yeah, I almost caught one.
Well, you deserve it. You deserve it because you know why? In case you don't know, which I know you do know. In case you don't know, you a whole legend out here. You a real... real staple in hip hop. You're a person. Let me finish giving you a flower. You're a person that we really, really sincerely respect, honor, and love wholeheartedly. And you need your flowers. You need to be praised. You need us blow up the ghetto. What is it? Ghetto Boys podcast.
Yeah.
Big up the Black Effect Network. Charlamagne and everyone
really
there.
Really doing it with you.
And everyone. Yeah. And, you know, we really just really, really, really wanted you to know how much you appreciate it. And we hopefully you leave here with that. And, you know, that's it. One love to motherfucking Scarface. God damn it.
No more horn.
No more horn. We just take a picture and you do some...